Hey. Hi, guys. Hi. Hey, guys, today's gonna be a good one. I can feel it. I can feel today's gonna be a good stream. Like, I feel that energy coursing through every single part of me. Every single square inch of my body feels that this is gonna be a good stream. Hi, guys. Hey, Puggers Carlson, thanks so much for the resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Zays, thanks for the resub. Wait, what's the song? What's the song that's like, wait. Okay, hold on.
I'm gay.
Oh, congrats, Bundle of Bees. Hey, chat, how are we? Hey, hey, are you all ready to see something awesome? It's my face. Yeah, it's my face. Thanks for streaming, now I can sub. That sounds like a good deal. Wait, that sounds awesome. Hi, guys. Hey, hey, who's here? Hey, it's me. I just have one thing to say. I'm crying cause I love you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I've just always wanted to do that. So that was okay. Well, now all right, well, it was kind of underwhelming and I kind of feel like a loser now. Like, I just don't even feel cool. Was it cool? Was what I did cool? Guys, was that cool? Or do you need to see it again? Because, like, that was... Okay, it was kind of awesome. Wait, was that cool? Hold on. Okay, okay. Wait, okay. If it was cool, then I'll do it again. All right. I'm crying because I love you. Yeah, 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 yeah. Never been in love before. Can we take attendance? Can we take attendance for the stream? I stole these pajama pants from my high school theater department. Oops. I said I did something bad. But why does it feel so good? Me when I... say here, okay, say here if you're here. If you don't say here, you're gonna be counted absent. If you get absent three times, you get sent to the principal's office. I don't know, I make something up.
Hi, so I've been waiting so long for a TTS to tell you how much I loved the Fear HQ and Crowd streams. I can't believe it was Winifred Untz or that you made fried chicken. I want to so much cooking when I move out.
Wait, I'm so glad you liked those. That's so fun to hear feedback from that. Thank you. Thank you, Howard. Thank you. Thank you for the resub. And Zach the Funky Monkey, thank you for the 100 bits. Hey, chat, how are we? Everyone say one word in chat that you, that describes how you are today or how your day was. You wanna know how my day was? No, you don't. You really don't, because I sat here and I was on my computer the whole day and I literally don't think I did a single thing. I wrote a script for a prank call and that was my work day. Ooh! 18 and young and successful. Like, my parents' friends look at me and they're like, you are going places. You are an entrepreneur on the internet. You are an entrepreneur. You are reinventing the internet. You are taking advantage of the current social media market. I'm like, what? Like all I did today was write a script for a prank phone call. Like, I'm not Wreck-It Ralph breaking the internet. Wreck-It Ralph came out, I don't know, a while ago. It was, like, its anniversary yesterday. Chat, wait, did you guys describe how your day was? Wait, are we doing confessions again? We are, but there's a twist this time, okay? I twist things up. Wait, chat is so delayed. Is chat really delayed? Wait, say one if you see... Hey, say one when you hear this. Okay, it's not bad. Refresh. Guys, if it's delayed for you, refresh. Also... I'd like to show you all something that I made, all right? It's really cute and sweet and fun. I don't know how I'm going to show you this because Liquid doesn't work like that. Oh, the Cat Gamer, they were the resub with Prime. Yo, if you want to subscribe, all you got to do is be like, oh, why are so many people still saying one? Okay, let me. Basically, I need to walk a little bit. What we're doing today is you guys are going to submit your confessions or we're mixing it up for this one. If you have someone else's secret that you want to tell, as long as it's anonymous, okay? As long as it's anonymous, I will let you tell other people's secrets on this stream, but only if it's anonymous, only if it's, is it really delayed for some people? Piso, are you a quirked up white boy? Some may call me that. Some also may call me other names. Is it really delayed for some people? Did you see Harry Ween? What is Harry Ween? What did you just call me? Ew. I don't want to see a Harry Ween. You've not seen stuff about Harry Ween? Guys, is that a Harry Styles thing? Oh. Okay. Because they need to come up with a different name for that. No offense to Harry Styles or his brand or his fans. Please don't come after me. But Harry Ween? That sounds like some British slang for something that I don't want to talk about. Also, this is 2 shots of espresso. I mean, think about a British person being like, did you see the Harry Ween? Okay, this is 2 shots of espresso because I was like, because espresso cures my depresso. Derp. I'm in my millennial era. Piso, the Eddie Baby song reminds me of you. That's really endearing. And okay, this tastes like actual doo-doo poopy. Like, sorry, I'm laughing at me saying doo-doo poopy. I need to talk. It, like, is actually delayed, like, 2 minutes. Refresh. Is it really that delayed for some people? Okay, well, you'll figure it out on your own. Pisa, what are your thoughts on Ohio? I don't have thoughts on things that don't exist. Funny Ohio joke. Because Ohio jokes aren't becoming overused on the internet at all. Okay, so this is 2 shots of espresso. What am I doing? Let me explain the stream first so that you guys can do stuff. So, thank you so much for the hype train. If you guys want to gift any subs, it's really appreciated. It goes toward my I'm raising 18 children right now, and just like every penny goes to them. And by 18 children, I mean it feels like there are 18 children running around in my brain. How do I make them stop? So, anyways, like I was saying, we're doing another confession stream. Now, you're really pretty today. Thank you, Lucas Live. So I wasn't pretty the other days. Oh. Oh, so I'm ugly. Oh, so I'm ugly. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you, I appreciate it. I do feel like I look more Piso 4 today than other days. Do I look more like myself or less like myself than I usually do? Can you tell I don't know what I look like? What I was trying to say, chat, you're distracting. The problem with chat is there's a million different conversations going on and I want to be involved in any of them. Mag? By the way, is it Magda? Is it Magda? And I've been calling you Mag this whole time. Magda, thank you so much for the 5 gifted. That is a crazy amount of, that will feed 5 of the children inside of my head and I appreciate it. And they'll keep on thriving. Okay, thank you for the 5 gifted. Drake's in chat from Magda. My name is Magda, but people do call me Mag. Which do you prefer? And be honest. You can say, I don't really care, but I feel like, do you? You know? You're really Piso 4ing today? Good. Okay, so we need to do a confession stream because I wanted to rank your confessions, right? Okay, I have a tier list here, and I'm going to show it to you, and you're all going to be so happy with it, okay? Is this the button? Oh, wrong button. That was risky. Wait. Oh my gosh. Ah! Okay. So here is our tier list. Here are the different tiers that we're going to go through. Okay, let's start at the bottom here. All right, number one is same. Either this confession is something... By the way, while I'm doing this, submit confessions using the command exclamation point form in chat. You can type out a little confession, either something that you've done or something that you know someone else has done, something that you need to get off your chest. It is completely anonymous. And you're welcome. I hope the children enjoy it. Okay, awesome. Good. Good to hear. Okay, so same means that I would do it or I have done it. Not chill means you're just not vibes. Like, it's like not a great thing to do, but also that's just not chill. This one is like redemption is possible. Like, you did this thing and it was terrible, but like you can come back from it. This one is stay far away from me. I don't want to be near you. Please get away from me. This one is you should get your own TLC show. Because, like, I feel like some confessions warrant that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you need a little TLC show. I want a TLC show. And then the top one is I'm calling the cops. Because sometimes you guys just say confessions that are literal crimes. Like, literal evidence that could be used in court. Hi, Piso. I've been watching your streams lately. Miss them, but I'm here now. Welcome. Thanks so much, Aurora. Hi. Also, yeah, this is a new form from the other day. I'm sorry for doing two confession streams kind of back to back, but cheers. Wait, should we take a shot of espresso? I promise that the ending, this is actually so gross. Cheers. My fingers are wrapped around. I've got a little hold on it. It's okay, I love the confession stream. Okay, real. Cheers! Why'd the chat get so freaking quiet? I fell off. I'm joking. Okay, I'm taking a shot of espresso. I feel the need to say espresso every single time. Here we go! Hey! Guys, this is me getting lit right now. This is actually gonna be gross. Okay, pinky up, you're right. Okay, I need to, like, drink the rest of it or else I'm never... Ew, that's so gross. Ugh! Nasty. Okay, there's a little bit left. Hold on. Why didn't it... I actually almost threw up from that one, and I don't know why. Why didn't you make a latte or something? Because I don't want dairy right now. Because dairy makes me a little freak. that was nasty. Okay, you guys have submitted quite a few confessions. I'm ready to dive in. Also, there might be some gaming with friends tonight as well. That gaming with friends, you're not going to want to miss it. If it happens. It's going to depend on my friend's availability. Stuff like that. Jake asked new emotes. Yeah, but for some reason they're not showing up here. I promise that the ending always stays the same and there's no good reason to say this. Okay. My boss made me take a shot of espresso at work. Oh my gosh. Is that like... I mean, I guess... I don't know. That's not ethical. It's probably legal. It's just not ethical. Wait, why am I Judge Judy? Have you guys seen videos of Judge Judy? I saw people being like, comment on videos of Judge Judy and be like, she needs to chill. Like, no. I love her just the way she is. All right. Also, there's going to be an ad playing soon. Spin Pigeon, thank you so much for the resub. Thank you. There's going to be an ad playing soon. If you get the ad, I'm sorry. Ad, support the streamer. Let's all chant that when the ads happen. All right. Here is the first confession. All right. I told my friends I was bi. I was. And I told them to not tell anyone. But then they started asking questions to me, but they'd say it quite loud, and then people started hearing our conversations. So the next time one of my friends asked me about it, I just gaslit them and into... Sorry, someone in chat just said, "Hi, Piso, I just ate an expired PB&J sandwich." How did you... Okay. So I just gaslit them into thinking it never happened and I was straight the whole time and they actually believed it. Okay, this one isn't, like, bad. This one isn't bad. I'm not even gonna rank this one. Because this one's just like, you did what you had to and I'm proud of you. You know what I'm saying? I'm proud of you for everything you've done. When I was 8, my dad kicked my dog. So I lied to my mom and told her he cheated on her. She believed me and kicked him out for a couple months. That's kind of like... That's kind of deserved. That's kind of deserved. Okay, wait. Where do we put this? Where do we put this on my little meter? Guys. Where does this go? Because this is kind of like a W. This is kind of a W. Where does this go? When I was 8, my mom... I think same. Not chill? Wait, you think this isn't chill? Well, the person was 8. This person was 8, though. You think redemption is possible? Wait, okay. What do you guys think? Chat, welcome back from the ads. Welcome back, non-subs. Welcome back from the ads. Redemption is possible? Is this not something that you guys would have done? When I was 8, my dad kicked my dog, so I lied to my mom and told her he cheated on her. She believed me and kicked him out for a couple of months. Would you? No, I wouldn't do that. No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't do... That's messed up. I would not do that. That's messed up. I'm gonna put not chill. Because you lied to your dad, but you were trying to save your dog. And I think saving your dog is chill. Or wait, you lied to your mom. You lied to your mom about something very serious. You were also 8 years old. I think we need to remember that. I think we need to remember you were also 8 years old. Also, the taste of espresso in my mouth is still in my mouth. I'm gonna head to the toilet. BRB. Alright, thanks for the info. Thanks for letting me know. Okay. Next. One time I wrote about my crush and my entire school found out it was on Wattpad. Why would you publicly post a Wattpad story about someone that you know in real life? Why would you do that? I think that you guys, what are your thoughts? What are you thinking? I'm kind of leaning toward giving this person their own. I'm kind of leaning towards giving this person their own TLC show. I kind of want to watch a TLC show because their entire school found out. Like, imagine going to school after figuring out that... These streams make me feel a lot better about myself. Can I say that? Is that messed up? It's... you think you had an embarrassing moment. This person's Wattpad got exposed to their school. To their school! They said, "Thanks, Piso." You're welcome. That's why I stream. It's to feel better about myself. I get validation from the people. I embarrass them in front of themselves. And then I move on with my life. Ew. That sounded true. That's not true at all. I just like to make jokes, okay? I'm gonna eat. If you eat these little freaks, you... Ew. Ew, 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 ew. You're a freak if you eat these little guys. Yum, yum, yum. Nah, they are good. No, these give me the worst sensory issues. I try to... I'm thinking about them and I actually need to put them down. It like makes me want to shrivel up and become a little raisin and live in a little... Yes, the texture. Thank you. Thank you. The texture is so gross. It's so bad. The texture is so bad. Ugh. Okay. Why is it crunchy yet soft? That's what they used to call me in high school. Crunchy yet soft. You don't want to know why. All right. Let's keep moving on to the next confection. Let's move on. I accidentally caused a school lockdown. LOL. So you can't just say that and provide no context. Mom, today at school, I accidentally, caused a little school lockdown. One time at my school, someone... One time at my school, someone hacked the school email and sent out mass emails as the principal to the entire school corporation. I don't know how they did that, but they genuinely did. And like, I don't want to say what the email said, because they're like, it was goofy, but it was weird. There were some goofy ones, and then there were some like, yeah, you need to be locked up. Okay, I accidentally caused a school lockdown. I don't know where this goes. Where does this go, chat? 44% said yes. That's, you're nasty, chat. Also, to all the people who didn't vote on the poll, you're nasty too. Stand up for what you believe in. Don't let the liberals lie. Where should I go, guys? Should I? Since there's no context, I don't know if I want this. I don't know. I'm not gonna, because it's so hard to tell what you did. And so, like, what you did is so important. One time my BFF's ex... my ex BFFs were fighting, so I just left. It was my own house. I mean, like, that's not really what I want right now. Like, I'm kind of bored of that. Like, that's like, oh, chat. Okay, chat ate that up. Chat, can you pretend like that was the most outlandish confession? Because I'm sensing neon coming on, and I just had two shots of espresso. Ew, sometimes I speak like voice lines. Like if I were a little doll and you pressed a button. I feel a yawn coming on. Like, I'm going to light that doll on fire. Alright, I ate dog kibble, and I also eat Play-Doh, because it's scrumptious. Alright. I ate dog kibble, and I also... Okay, yeah, you're going to... I almost said hell. I meant, you're gonna go to... Please stay far away from me. Or no, I'll say redemption's possible. I think there's hope. Sorry for almost sending you to hell. That was a joke. That was a misspeak. Please, I would watch a TLC show about that. We have different, very different levels of standards for entertainment. Those were a lot of words that I'm not even sure I understood. Do you guys think that there's hope for them? Depends on how old they are, there might not be hope. I'm gonna put, I believe in them. I believe that redemption is possible. And I'm gonna put that there. I mean, like, if you eat a little... Wait, this is literally a... Wait, okay, no, this is literally My Strange Addiction, like, TLC show. Whoever said that was kind of right, and I, like, I'm sorry. This is literally, like, a My Strange Addiction, like, I eat Play-Doh. I eat Play-Doh, and I love it. But I love it. Okay, let's go to the next confession. I have accidentally exploded both a Wi-Fi router and a phone charger before. How do you explode a phone? What are you doing? Are you doing this on purpose? You seem dangerous. Maybe you have, like, little secret powers that you just are keeping from us. Maybe you have little electric powers. Maybe you're, like a Steve Jobs Elsa. Ooh, I need to see that fanfic. Yo, someone link me the Steve Jobs Elsa fanfic. I'll read it on stream. All right. I'm gonna put this in... Where does this go? I'm gonna say stay far away from me because you're a danger. My friend at camp exploded a lamp on accident. That's kind of camp. Because it's like the... I used to eat dog treats when I was younger. They were really good. I don't think I ever ate... Okay, the bacon ones were kind of tempting. Like Pete Davidson. Bacon, bacon, bacon. Do you guys know the video I'm talking about? Pete Davidson going, bacon, bacon, bacon. Wait, you guys don't know the video I'm referencing? Bacon, bacon, bacon. Wait, do you want to see it? Hold up. Okay, I pull up. Hop out of the after party. You and all your friends. Okay, wait. It's Pete Davidson. He's on a Zoom call. Bacon, bacon, bacon. He's on a Zoom call, and then he glitches a little bit. You'll see. Okay. Ready?
Okay, great. That's awesome.
Well, you froze. Pete?
Bacon, bacon, bacon.
Bacon, bacon, bacon. I think that was, yeah, that was definitely a... Why is, like, a lullaby playing? Okay. Turning this off immediately. Bacon, bacon, bacon. All right. Let's keep going. What do you guys think? Someone who eats dog treats... When they were younger, they were really good. Well, you said when you were younger, so that's kind of like a... I'm gonna say not chill. I'm gonna say that's not chill. Because it's not so bad that I don't... It's not so bad that I want you to stay away from me, and it's not something that I did when I was younger. It's definitely something I thought about doing, but it was not something that I did. Because I was better than you. You guys think redemption is possible? Yeah, because you did have redemption. Oh, you're so right about that. Because they literally did get redeemed. Aw. Wait, that's like your coming of age story. Aw, wait, perks being a wallflower, like you eating your dog treats in the tunnel. We could be heroes! Like... If you've seen that movie, that joke is funny. My friend likes someone and he doesn't like her back. He told me he likes me and I didn't tell her. When there's too many characters involved, I tune out. I've had a crush on my best friend for a year. She's also been dating someone for about a year. That's just like boring. Sorry. That's messed up to call your experience boring, but... My assistant principal got arrested today. Oh my gosh. That is some drama on the Snapchat stories. I know the private stories were eating that one up. I know the private stories were posting about that little assistant principal. Chat, we need context with these. Exactly. Exactly. Do people even use Snapchat private stories? Ooh. I think they do. Yeah. I think they... Do they? Do the kids still use private stories? I do. Well, not really. What I use private stories for is like every once in a while something really, really cool will happen in my life. And I'll be like, oh my gosh, I need to tell all the people that I know about this. And I'll be like, okay, wait, I'm just going to put it on here. And then everyone looks at it and no one slides up. I'm like, yo, I just had a meet and greet. And then they're all like, oh. Tap. Like, oh, what? You would have swiped up if I would have said swipe up for a TBH. But you don't want to know what I'd say in a TBH. That's like a cool thing to say before walking away, like from someone. And for the record, you don't even want to know what I would say in a TBH. I've been having dreams. Wow. Okay. I'm not... Because there's no context, I'm not going to rank that one. When I was pretty young, my dog would poop in my room. Guys, I almost just swore there. Don't catch Piso for swearing. My friends swipe up or use their Snapchat stories, and I always swipe up to provide commentary on every image. I think I've talked about this, but when I'm bored, I'll just screenshot random Snapchat stories and slide up on random Snapchat stories. Like, someone will post, like, an image of their lunch, and I'll be like, that's cool. Like, I'll, like, slide up and be like, this looks yummy. And they, like, don't even know who I am. Do you guys have, is it just me, or do you guys have, like, 100 people on your Snapchat that you just have no idea who they are? Or how they got there, or when you added them. Snapchat is a fever dream. Okay. When I was pretty young, my dog would poop in my room, and I would put it under my dresser because I didn't want him to get in trouble. I mean, at least you didn't kick your dad out of the house. My snap maps are full of randoms. Oh my gosh, people would post on their Snapchat stories and be like, I need to fill out this part of the map. What? You need to go fill out a job application. Like, they're like, I don't have anyone in Brazil. Yeah, who are you gonna know from Brazil? Didn't people do that? Didn't people literally do that? Like, you live in Illinois. No one in Arizona wants to talk to you. Katie's girl, thank you so much for the resub. Happy 2 months. Thank you. And thank you for the raid. Welcome, Raiders. Hello.
Happy 2 months.
I don't know beating if that's something heart, that you guys experience, but I think heart. That I have a ton of people on my Snapchat. Yeah. I also went through a little hoe phase on Snapchat, so we won't talk about that, though. Let's just keep on moving. Okay, where does this go? I think that this is sweet. This is like good intention. Whoa, Piso. I was mostly joking. Where's this going? Redemption is possible. I mean, I guess they. I think maybe same. They were defending their dog's honor. Yeah. I mean, if I was super young and I don't want my dog to get in trouble, like it's like if your friend does something and you're covering it up. Like when you're young, like sometimes all you have is your little dog. Hold on, I need to close my door. Now it's just me and you. I don't know who that sounded like, but I don't think I want to know. All right, I'm going to put it in same. That's our first samesies. Oh, wait, I'm a relatable streamer, and that's what people need to talk about more. I lied to this girl I hated when I was younger and told her that when she turns 10, she's going to be taken by aliens. Turns out when she was 10, something happened to her really bad. Was she Addison from the Zombies trilogy? Answer honestly. I don't know. What do you guys think? What do you guys think about this one? People make fun of the Zombies movies way too much. Yeah, probably because they're the worst. They're so camp, but they're so bad. Like they're genuinely just terrible Disney Channel original movies. But I love to watch them. I just like burped. That was actually I don't burp ever. I don't burp ever, dude. That was like Piso 4 history. Piso, you look like the main guy. He is so hot. Piso, the type of guy to say, guys, you're gonna want to see this when he's watching the news. Okay. I'm saying, okay, wait. I'm moving my chair up because I feel short. There we go. That's a little bit better. I think that this is messed up. I do. Especially something bad actually did end up happening. We're gonna put this in. What do you guys think? Police? That's not the police. Okay, actually. I mean, like. This is kind of evidence, isn't it? Stay away. I'll put it in stay far away from me. I think that's good. I think that's a good one. I used to play love games with my Barbies, meaning they were all lesbians in high school. Love games. Yeah, that's definitely going insane. That's definitely something that I would have done when I was younger. It was like when you like signed up as a when you like when I pretend to not be a guy on like Animal Jam and stuff so that I could like date like other guy like but I it was just for fun. It was just love games. Do you guys ever catfish on Club Penguin? I often just set my phone down when I get a call or text from someone I don't like and pretend not to see it. Yeah, that's the same. That's the same moment. Same! Not you being relatable. I sleep with 10 teddies at night and I'm 17. I think that this is real. You're real for that. I sleep with, your mom at night and I'm 18. I forgot the word for mom, which doesn't come in handy, when you're trying to make a your mom joke. Hopeful B, thank you so much for the sub. Thank you. I appreciate it. Okay. Why the... I'm a band kid. I'm just gonna skip that one. We don't need to see that. I'm in love with my best friend and I give her morning and goodnight messages, but she does back. IDK. I've done that with friends too, where I've like given them goodnight and good morning messages, but not had romantic feelings for them. You should go see Cupid, the little baby with the bow and arrow. See what he has to say about this. I'm not the love expert. Once I peed on the carpet in front of my cousin and then had her tell my mom it was the dog that had been house trained my entire life. This is problematic behavior. I think please stay far away from me. No, I think redemption is possible. You know, I think that everyone needs a good I peed on the floor story at least once in their life, and then they can and then they can redeem themselves, right? Right, chat? Right? Everyone needs a pee on the floor story. Right? Right? Vrin Vrinster, thank you so much for the gifted sub. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Where can I find the Peaceful 4 podcast? It'll be on my Patreon, which is coming soon. It's coming as soon as I can start pushing out YouTube videos once a week. Yay! I have not peed on the floor once in my life. I was making a little joke, and if you can appreciate that, I liked my best friend. Bored. I told my best friend I liked, no, I loved her. Then she said she knew and continued to tell me she loved me back, and now we're dating. This happened 5 minutes ago. Okay, this one's actually really sweet. I think I know exactly what tier it should go in. It's really sweet. I'm really happy for your happy relationship and for your success. That's really good for you. That's really good. Please stay far away from me. I don't want to see your happy relationship. In fact, you're lucky I'm not calling the cops. I rest my case. Okay, whatever. I'm skipping that. Fry boy from Hershey Park, though. Not gonna lie. What on earth are you talking about? What is Fry Boy? Okay, let's look this up. Fry Boy Hershey Park. Thank you for the 5 gifted. Thank you. Thank you. Snowy DVD, thank you for the 5 gifted. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Who is the TikTok star five boy? Fry Boy. Fry Boy. TikTok star. Am I this old already? Thank you for the 5 gifted, by the way, guys. Thank you. Guys, what's going on here? Am I old? Who is this boy? Are people thirsting over a guy with clown makeup on? Is that what's going on? Is that all I need to do? Becoming a boomer hits fast. I really speed ran this whole boomer thing. Yeah, unfortunately. Guys, he's so creepy. Why do people like him? I don't know. I mean, like, Hades from Hercules is always, like, trying to kill people and stuff. But, like, sometimes I wish he would have pulled me down under. You know what I'm saying? And by down under, I meant the underworld. That was not a euphemism. But... thank you for the 20 bits, Neptunic Lights. Thank you. Thank you. Alright, I'm just gonna skip that one, because I don't know who Fry Boy is. Once there was like 7 fights in one day at my high school. That is a purge. that is the purge. How did that happen? Your school tried to start... The Thinning, starring Logan Paul or Jake Paul and Peyton List. Whoa, so many memories just came back. Did you guys watch The Thinning? The Thinning. It was Logan Paul. Chat, look at this. Logan Paul and Peyton List in the movie The Thinning. It was a YouTube original. I loved it. Peaceful, are you going to dye your hair light brown? No. I don't know where you heard that. But I'm not. Get over it. Sorry. No, I was obsessed with that movie. I watched it on the bus. I screen recorded the whole thing at home on Wi-Fi so I could watch it on the bus. Thank you for the resub, love Emma. Thank you. And Tile SK, thank you so much for the resub. Thank you. Ooh. Yeah, that's true. Every time someone resubs, I do sing a personalized song. Also, there's an ad starting in 20 seconds. So if you want a song and you don't want ads, because the thing that's going to happen during the ads is going to blow your mind. Quick chat, what's something impressive and cool that I can do during the ads? Couldn't you just download it on Netflix? Is The Thinning on Netflix now? It's gonna blow your socks off. You're gonna want to see this. Once when I was like 7, I ate a lot of grapes before I went on a jet ski, and I crapped myself midair after being thrown. I also peed on my mom's shoes in the woods now. Or in the woods once. Some people just were not meant to have a bowel system. All you ate was grapes. Wait, after being thrown, why were you thrown on a jet ski? Isn't that what tubing is? Are you talking about tubing? Whoever was driving the jet ski was not doing a good idea. Wait, are you the duck from the duck lemonade stand video? I see what he wanted those grapes for now. He wanted to go hang out on the jet ski. Only in Ohio. Here they go. Now tell everyone your iPhone password. What? The thing is if I tell you guys my iPhone password, what's it gonna do? Like, what are you gonna do with my iPhone password? When I go to VidCon? Peace, so I'm literally in the middle of nowhere. My phone's at 2%, but the Peaceful Fortnite grind never stops. Hey. Thanks for being here. Thanks for 17 months of stream.
Thanks for 17 months of amazing streams. Best comfort streamer on Twitch, Piso Hype.
Hi, Lix. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you for being here 17 months. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. That's awesome. Okay. What is this person? The person who pooped midair, crapped themselves midair after being thrown on a jet ski, also peed on their mom's shoes in the woods. Both sound like things that would happen in, like, Netflix original thrillers. Have you ever watched a Netflix original horror movie? Because they are actually so... They are so boring and random. They're so random. A TLC show? I don't know if I want to watch that show. Alright, I'm just gonna put this in there. Alright. Let's decide, chat. Where's it going? Redemption is possible. It happened twice. Do we really believe that? I think stay far away from me because I don't want my shoes to be peed on. Or my jet ski to be crapped on. Ooh, what if I get a jet ski? That'd be like kind of cool. Okay, I'll put that on my to-do list. Maybe I'll go out and buy one tomorrow. Me acting like I could go and, like, maybe I should just start pretending like I'm a really big influencer. Like, maybe I should just start living like one until it manifests itself into being true. Neptunic Lights, thank you so much for the sub. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Neptunic Lights, thank you. Thanks. Next. This girl came up to me and said, Ni hao. I'm Thai. Oh. That is just... That's just... Why do they not have... Why do they not have, like, common decency class? In school. I guess it's not something that should need to be taught, but I every single day I think it is something that needs to be taught. You know what I'm saying? Just like having common decency of like what you say to people. Cops? Okay, yeah. Let's call the cops. I wish you could like call the cops just to talk. You know what I'm saying? Like I wish that I could just like talk to the cops like I'm just like hanging out. You know what I'm saying? It's because people can't tell the difference between the different types of Asians. Yeah. Just befriend the cops. I don't know if I should do that. I don't know if I should do that. I don't know if that's a great idea. Okay. Why do I keep saying okay? Like, okay, why the frick? Okay. I shoved a ring pop in my ear hole, mixing it around the... I shoved a ring pop in my ear hole, mixing it around with the juicy taste of my earwax, and licked it. Ooh. How are we feeling, chat? I like to imagine that this is the start of the Wattpad fanfic we were talking about earlier that got exposed to their school. YN. Okay. That's just, like, not even something that can be real, right? That can't be real. That, like, literally can't be something that actually happened. I'm, like, traumatized at the image of this. Be real. How'd they fit a ring pop in their ear? They have a huge ear. Okay, there's three choices. They have a huge ear, a tiny ring pop, or just a whole lot of perseverance. You can fit anything in anything if you try hard enough. Yikes. That should have been my senior quote. I shouldn't have said it like that, should I? Yikes. You know, I'm really glad the footprint that I'm leaving on this. Can I get a real job after this? What if this doesn't work? Because I just said that. Am I going to be able to get a real job? Guys, can I be famous forever? Please. Please, 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 please. Please. Can I be famous forever? Will you guys let me be famous forever? Okay, don't let me- What? Don't say no! You guys don't realize how fragile I am these days. All of you here. All of you, please. Please. Okay. Peace up forever, famous arc. Oh, okay, so we're having a poll for my fate. All right, thanks. Thanks. That's great. No, that's just lovely. I'm going to turn the light down. Hold on. Okay. Perfect. Okay, now that's perfect. Who just said Filza in all caps? Hi, Filza. Wait, this is a good time for Filza to join. So I made you a quote book. I don't ever want to see that. I don't ever want to see that. That's really sweet that you did that though. Okay, let's just yeah, that is going in the cops. That is going in the cops section. I'm calling the cops. Let's go to the next confession and hopefully it has to be better than that, right? Once gave my autistic friend a big spoon and said it was the only one there since I was mad at them. We had a ton of small spoons. They got revenge, don't worry. I'm confused on the relevancy of all the details in this. What does that even mean? Okay, everyone's saying what? Okay. I don't know what's going on. No, because I get it. Thank you for the 140 bits. Who is Molly? I just don't know. I don't know if I understand. So I'm just gonna. I don't know. I'm just. I'm just gonna move on from that. I'm gonna move on from that one. Sorry, my brain is kind of all over the place. I have trouble with focus, but it's getting better. It's getting better. Wait, did I tell you guys that I scheduled an appointment? I scheduled an appointment over the weekend to get hopefully maybe like actually officially diagnosed with ADHD, and then maybe I'll get medication, and then maybe I'll be able to do my job. And then maybe I'll be able to do my job that I'm supposed to do. Who is Molly? Thank you for the 200 bits. And Lekio, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Don't take the meds. Okay, yeah. All right, yeah. You said don't take the meds. What I heard was never share medical details with my chat, because they will tell me what to do and not do. I had a dream about peeing and peed my bed last week. That's fair though. We need to normalize wetting the bed. If you wet the bed every now and then, I think you're valid. I'm gonna start a Bed Wetters Anonymous. And then what are you gonna do? I like your chaotic energy. Guys, I like my chaotic energy on stream as well. No, I'm not going to open up a discussion about medication, actually. I'm going to say one thing. I like my chaotic energy on stream, and that will not change. What needs to change is me like sitting down in front of my desk and not being able to do anything or focus on anything or remember anything or like focus or like feel. That's what needs to change. So like off stream is when I need a little medication. Or maybe I don't even need medication. Maybe I just need... I have therapy tomorrow, so maybe that's what I need, you know? Okay, let's go to the next one. My grandma had to go to the hospital because I dropped toothpaste in her bathroom and she slipped and she broke her ankle and she's 84. Oh... Okay, but did 9 out of 10 dentists recommend this toothpaste? Because that's on them. That's on the dentist. I'm gonna put this at same, because like, I mean, I think I dropped something on my grandma's floor if she were alive. We'll put that in same. LOL. Next confession. I hit a teacher in the head with a long piece of wood. Okay, an actual crime. Was it on purpose? What were you doing? Yeah, that one's going to the cops. Thank you though. Like, people are like, this is a goofy little confession, and then it's a crime. Okay. Next. My friend is dating her best friend, and their boyfriend told me not to tell anyone, but I trust you, so I'm telling you. That's good that you told me, because I don't understand what that meant. I don't process that. I don't really know if this counts as a confession. So when I was in sixth grade, we had a hard quiz. My friend failed. I passed. Then, wait, when she told me she failed, I felt bad and traded tests with her so she didn't get grounded. You're a hero. You traded tests? Wait. Did you not have names on the papers? Wait, chat, can we think through the logistics? How do you trade tests with someone? Eraser? Right, but they would have already gotten them back. They would have already gotten their tests back and the tests would have already been graded. I know how an eraser works, chat. You don't have to explain an eraser to me. But how do you change the... If it was already graded... What? How... I don't understand No, erase the name, bro. No, I know, but think about it. Think about it, okay? I assumed erase names, and then they just brought home each other's tests. Oh, it wasn't for the grade book. It was for the parent. Thank you, chat. Thank you. Chicken Nug 20, thank you so much for the resub. Resub, 8 months. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate it. Bacon, bacon, bacon. Sorry. All right, that's sweet. Let's say I'm gonna put that in same. Perfect. I've been stealing from Target a lot, and my bag was so full of makeup and clothes, but I can't stop. It feels so good. I'm also so poor. That's how I get my mom's gifts. They are stolen. And my bag? You said my bag was so full of makeup and clothes, but I can't stop. It feels good. How do I simultaneously put this in the cops, but also same? Not that I would ever do that for all the cops watching. Yo, we have any cops in chat? 1, 2, 3 if you're a cop in chat. All right, we need a ban on anyone who says 1, 2, 3. Immediate ban. Oh, am I gonna sneeze? You know what I thought was so funny when I was younger? When I'd say, if you got an issue, get yourself a tissue. That, like, brought tears to my eyes. I don't shut up, I grow up. And when I look at you, I throw up. Alright, I'm gonna put this in the cops because technically it's a crime, but also kind of same. At least you're like gifting things to your mom. You know what I'm saying? Like you're not just keeping it all for yourself. But is that morally worse or better? Is it worse to steal things and give it to people? Worse or better? Because you didn't actually buy the thing for the person. I don't know, dude. That's... Oh, you put the wrong confession in cops? Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Bacon, bacon, bacon. Alright, next. I used to bite my toenails like I bite my fingernails and swallow them. I would bite them even with the dirt stuff, too. Guys, what do I even do with them? What am I supposed to do there in this situation? There should have been an Ohio category. Let's just, I think I'm just gonna put this in stay far away from me, because no one's gonna watch a TV show. No one's gonna watch a TLC show about that. It's not criminal evidence, but I genuinely want you to be sent to the moon. Like, I think that you need to start a new life on the moon. So, that's my take. Maybe Pluto, the moon is too close. No, because we need to keep an eye on them. Make sure they don't escape. I have been in love with my best friend for 9 years and I don't know how to tell him. Just be like, yo, I have a crush on you. It's easy. Guys, love is easy. You just have to, like, do, like, you just have to, like, be like, hey. Wait, I kind of hate that. That's more than a crush. It's more than a crush, more than a like, more than a love. You've never been in a relationship in your life? Oh, and where'd you get that evidence from? Decently moody underscore. Estelic said your room looks cool. Thanks, Estelic. Wait, where are you with Estelic, VC? Hi, Squid Kid. What's up? Wait, yeah, I definitely have been in a relationship before. Multiple, even. I just haven't talked about them because I haven't moved out yet. You guys aren't ready for the stories that I can tell once I move out. I just don't want these people showing up to my house. I don't want them to know, because these people know where I live. I'm in love with my English teacher, and I've told her on multiple occasions, and I don't think she believes me. Yep, that's gonna go into the cops. So that's gonna go into the cops. Why the pride flag too? Why do you have to bring us into that? Gay people are supposed to use their English teachers as their parental figures, not as the parents of their children. And I'll stand by that. I'll die on that hill. We're gonna put this in the jail section. Send in the rednecks, all of them, spin round and round. Wait, Squid, what did you say? Because I didn't read your chat, sorry. Estelic said your room looks cool, and then no other message from that. Okay, I guess that was all they had to say. Isn't it sad that I'm gonna leave this room? Guys, I'm gonna leave this room in like a month. Can you believe that? The next setup better look so good. I don't know how to make it look so good. Wait, I didn't think about that. Are you going to college? No, I'm moving out.
That's actually so sad. Like my life started in this room.
You've been saying a month for a month? No, because my plan was like end of November. I think I kept saying next month. Like last month, I was like next month. My plan is like end of November. He's so born here? No. I moved here when I was like... around when I was like 10. But I have lived in the same like area my whole life, kind of. I've cheated on literally all of my past tests in the past week because I have no brain cells. I don't believe in the no brain cells thing, but I do believe that you've cheated on your tests, and I'm gonna put that as same. Well, not that I would cheat, but I think it is a relatable thing. Actually, like, if I had the option to cheat in school, like, I was going, like, if I had the option, I was going to. Like, the honor system, when they're like, we're just, did you guys ever, oh, my comfy, oh, just chump, thank you for the, thank you for the sub, thank you, oh my gosh, I appreciate it so much, I appreciate it so much, little chumpy, what was I just saying? Oh, that's the problem, have you guys ever had, like, academic integrity preached to you? Or, like, had to sign a paper that was like, I promise I will not cheat on this. What? What do you mean academic integrity? I don't even know what the word integrity means. And I'm going to open up a secret new tab and Google it without the teacher seeing. I think that those, like, those games where you'd have to pretend to, like, kiss celebrities without getting caught. Without, you know what I'm saying? Getting, like, caught by the paparazzi. Do you know what? I don't know if that's it. Maybe that's too niche. But, like, that's what taught me how to cheat in school. Shocked that you don't know integrity because that's literally one of the main themes of my school. No, I was just making a little goofy joke. Most of the things I say are untrue. And that's just the truth. All right, let's go to the next one. Thank you for the 20 bits. Thank you. I'm in love with my best friend. I've known him for over a year now, and he's come to be my best friend. We have almost everything in common and love being around each other. However, he used to date my friend. I literally can't process any of the words that you are saying. Like, unless we are at the playground together and you're telling me all of this, I genuinely cannot. I don't know what words are being said. Is anyone understanding this? Hey, quick question. How do we do confessions? Just do exclamation point form in chat. When I was 4, my jacket fell in the toilet. It was only water in there. And I was, okay. It was only water, but like, you know what else has been in there. And I was too scared to tell my mom, so I still wore it in preschool. And I asher the jacket like a couple, I washed the jacket like a couple weeks later. I wore it all the time. You wore a toilet water jacket? You could have just washed it. Wait, you said when I was 4. I feel like that's an underestimate of your age. In my honest opinion. I think that you might have been less than 4 or older than 4. I'm skipping this confession because I think you're lying. I can't even remember stuff from when I was 4. No, literally. I can't remember stuff from... Mini Wheats. Okay. I was thinking of what I had for breakfast today. I used to play Animal Jam when I was about 7 or 8. And I had a boyfriend. We dated for 4 months. And turns out he was actually a girl. But that's when I found out I was bi. Whoa! And it all worked out in the end. I used to scam people on Animal Jam. Yeah. I did it. I'd scam people out of fox hats because I wanted all the rare items. And did I get them? Yes. Because, here's the origin story of when you first get scammed on Animal Jam. When you first get scammed on Animal Jam, it literally, you have to scam other people. You know what I'm saying? Like, I need to get revenge. And then I understand how supervillains are made. Did you scam me out of my headdress in 2017? I have no comment on that. Also, if my bunny, who is my wife, if anyone remembers my username, I actually don't remember my username. I think it was something like Polar Bear Muffins or something. Polar Bear Muffin, Polar Bear, I don't know. Muffin, thinking about you, nothing when I wake up. I missed that song. Sorry, my hair feels like it's like falling, like drooping. Like, it feels like it's melting off my head. I'm getting a haircut, like, tomorrow. No, Friday. Friday! That song's been out for almost a year. That's crazy. Carl's, thank you for the 5 gifted! Ah! Carl's, thank you so much. Drake's in chat for Carl's. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Bacon, bacon, bacon. Sorry, I can't get Pete Davidson out of my head today. Also, we're 15 subs away from sub goal. Have you watched Breaking Bad? Yeah. Okay, do you guys want to know something so real? I just lied to you. I've never seen Breaking Bad. I've never even watched one episode or a single second of any episode. I literally just lied and I didn't even realize it. Anyway, okay, let me tell you guys something about my life. This is a little secret. It's so easy to tell when my parents are or aren't home while I'm streaming. I feel so uncomfortable streaming when there's anyone else in the house. And that's not their fault at all. It's not like it could literally be anyone. It could be anyone in the world. It could be the person that I'm the most comfortable with in the entire world. And I literally do not want to stream in front of them. Like, it is actually the most humiliating, embarrassing thing ever. And like, my parents were like gone for like 35 minutes of the stream, and then like they got home, immediately my energy went down, and I could feel it, dude. I could feel it. And that is why I'm so excited to move out. Not only that, but I'm excited to be able to stream whenever I want, because right now it's hard for me to stream after the time of like 10 p.m. after they go to bed. I'm gonna stream whenever I want, whatever I want. I also want to make, in the house that I'm in right now, it's so hard for me to make content in any room that isn't my bedroom or my kitchen without being doxxed. I'm so excited to make content whenever I want, wherever I want, and however loud or energetic or or things out in the town and outside of my house. When I move out, my content will genuinely get 100 times better, and I promise that. Also, there's an ad right now. Ad support the streamer. Thanks for watching. There's a little tidbit for you. Ew, I just said tidbit.
There's a little tidbit. There's a little tidbit for you. It's more than a crush, more than a like, more than a love. Maybe I can make you mine. I ain't giving up. It's more than a crush, more than a like, more than a love.
I just needed that. Okay. Sorry, guys. I'm feeling derpy today. What is happening? Sometimes I have little impulses. Guys, I'm such an impulsive person. I'm risky. I need a peepo derp. Then people will finally understand me. Thank you for the 50 bits, Kylo Can't Swim. Also, thanks for watching the ad. The fit goes crazy. Thanks. So quirky and impulsive. I did a thing. So I did a thing. Are you refreshing it and seeing new confessions or like randomly generating them? I'm reading them. On the forum. I'm reading them on the forum. I'm reading the ones that my mods are choosing, if that makes sense. AI generated confessions. Yo, that's Elon Musk's future. I need a derp emote. Can I make a piso derp? Piso, by the way, the Discord mod came out. What? Wait, oh, server, by the way, the Discord mod came out. I was like, oh, congrats to the Discord mod. Aw, okay, sorry. We genuinely go back to confessions. Okay, one time I was... Piso, you need 7 TV, more emotes. I have 7 TV, I just don't have a ton of emotes. I'll get more. One time I was at school and I fell on concrete in first period, and then later after school I fell in a huge puddle in front of all of my friends. Wah! That was just not necessary. I'm sorry. OMG, concrete, it's giving love joy. Sure.
I'm skipping past that one. I read DNF fanfiction, like, genuinely.
All right. which one of you casted a curse on me? Put a curse on me. Is that what they're calling it these days? Cops, jail, Ohio. Guys, I read DNF fanfiction, like, genuinely. Okay, alright, where does this go? Probably... Sorry. Guys, don't admit to being a DNF stan. You'll start coughing uncontrollably. Okay. I'm gonna move this to redemption as possible.
DNF is basically Heartstopper.
Who's trying to kill me right now? That was a joke, by the way. The thing I said about Heartstopper. Perks of being a wallflower was my Heartstopper. Heartstop DNF was... I'm not gonna say that. Sorry, guys. I had a little coughing fit. That's what they called it when... Nope. That would have been a morbid joke. Morbid. Guys, that would have been one for the Patreon. That would have been dark humor. It would be funny if someone just gifted 15 subs and I was one of them. Yo, that would be funny. Oh, not funny to the mods, apparently. They deleted that quick. Okay, let's go to the next one. I have really, really bad anxiety, so I keep guns and knives in my room in case of a home invader. Okay. I mean, like... Who needs guns when you have these? Can I please catch a break? Oh my. Do you guys think that conservative people will change their mind about gun control if we call them, like, weak for not being able to defend... for not being able to defend themselves using their arms? Oh, looks like someone needs to be a little more alpha. That's a good point to make. Okay. Real masculine men use their arms. Well, that still kind of sounds like guns. Real Americans would break intruder weapons with their bare hands. Yeah, like Hagrid does in Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, the movie where they're in the scene where they're on the house in the middle of the island and he comes in and then the guy has the shotgun and he takes the end of the shotgun and he bends it upwards and it shoots upwards. And then the little boy grows a tail. Shout out to that movie. Okay. Wow, lots of mucus everywhere right now. Hold on. I'll drink a little more water. Real men just wouldn't have their houses intruded. Real men would grow a tail. This is more than a crush, more than a like, more than a love. Peace, I appreciate that you've been streaming for an hour 30. You're welcome. Maybe I'll stream for a long time tonight. What if I just stream till I fall asleep? I went to bed at 5 a.m. last night. Real men would turn into an alpha wolf demon on full moons. Subathon! No, I genuinely... What's the longest you streamed before? A week. And it was bad. It was so bad. No, it was actually the most fun I've ever had, but... I'll talk about that on the Patreon. I can't just, like, say... I can't get into it. When I was in 8th grade, I had, like, no friends and was a huge attention seeker because I just wanted people to like me. Unfortunately, this is an entire MLA format essay, so your attention seeking is not working because I'm skipping your confession. I confess that I learned how to swim in 4th grade. That's okay. Better late than never. Peace, so I don't go to bed. How many hours until everyone needs to go to bed? That's the real question. Or do you have what it takes to be a real alpha and stay awake? Peace, so sleep. Peace, so sleep. Peace, so sleep. Peace, so you need sleep. Peace, so you need a nap. Would you guys want to watch Rebecca Zamolo videos later tonight? What if I do that on main? Piso Baba, you need sleep. I have therapy. The only thing I have tomorrow is my therapy at 10 a.m. tomorrow. Hold on, I think I just remember that. It's either at 10 a.m. or 1. It genuinely might be at 10 a.m. and that might be problematic. Okay. Therapy tomorrow is at 10 a.m. I have to be up at 10 a.m. That's messed up. Except I will go to bed at 5 a.m., wake up at 10 a.m., do an hour of therapy. Or not, wake up at night, wake up at 9 a.m., do an hour of therapy, come back, sleep the rest of the day, wake up, not know what year it is. and then go to sleep. I once punched myself in the eye while trying to lift up my blanket, not realizing my foot was in it. That's kind of goofy. That's like a same-zee moment. Hear me out, cancel. Cancel my therapy to stream. I should be canceling my streams for therapy. This is the reason I need it. Sorry, I didn't mean that. Look at this. Okay, ignore how actually nasty and aged and... Oh, that was my home screen. Ignore how actually nasty my thing is, but like, look at this little sticker I got. It says, whoosh, you will now have a wonderful day. And I wish, like, it keeps me going throughout the day. Isn't that cute? Okay. I have a crush on this guy from school, and he likes me too, but he's not the best looking, and I want to date him, but people are gonna ask me why I'm with him, but IDK, he's genuinely a nice guy, and I don't know. Well, if you like him enough to not care about what other people think about his appearances, then you'll date him. You know what I'm saying? This is a beauty... Yeah, this is a self-reflection moment for you. I'm not gonna give you advice on that. You need to figure that out yourself. Once my best that's too long. Sorry. One day when I was in third grade, I thought I had to fart, but I didn't. I pooped, and then I was sitting in my poop. I didn't know what to do, so I ate a piece, then went to the bathroom. And you guys wanted me to cancel therapy tomorrow. Would you say that after we've read that? I love that you did include that it wasn't very good. Just in case I was considering. Can we move on? Yeah. Yeah. I don't even want to rank that one. I just want to keep going. I'm pansexual, but I don't think I can tell my parents because they don't believe in any genders other than male and female. I'm sorry that you feel like you can't tell your parents. I always get really stressed out about giving people advice about coming out to their family and sexuality and stuff. I think just like feel out your little situation because it's very relative. It's like, okay, therapists on TikTok. You ever see TikTok therapists trying to give advice to hundreds of thousands of people? Like sometimes it's nice, but also like a lot of these situations depend on the person, depend on the situation. On like a lot of the way that you should deal with something depends on the exact details of the situation. Like TikTok therapists, like... I saw a TikTok therapist the other day that was just like giving the worst advice I'd ever seen in my life. And everyone in the comments was like, oh yeah, okay. Like self-diagnosing themselves from TikTok. Sorry, I went on a tangent there. But I think do what's best for your situation and stay safe and know that you're valid. And we all appreciate you so much and you're awesome. Not really a confession, but me and my crush have been liking each other for 3 years and we're still so awkward with each other. Just be like, you want to kiss? Please? You want to kiss, please? To be like, you want a little, do you want a smackaroo? Ask if they want a smackaroo. That's what'll really get them. Please? Please? Do you want to kiss, please? Please? Please, do you want to kiss? How do I submit a confession? ! Form in chat. I don't actually like my girlfriend romantically, but she's... Oh, wow. Sorry, you just really dropped that on us. Okay, I don't actually like my girlfriend romantically, but she's the best friend of someone I'm close to, and that person I'm close to keeps pushing us to stay together. Okay, pretend I'm someone that you're close to right now, all right? Break up. Break up with your girlfriend. Break up with your girlfriend. Yeah. Yeah, you should break up with them because that's kind of messed up to be in a relationship that you don't want to be in. I mean, I'm sure that if you're being pressured, that's kind of a bad scenario, but you definitely just need to like break up with that person. Sorry, I'm like not ranking a ton of these because we don't have a ton of room left. So my cousin was being really like really horrible to me and my sister once. So the next time we saw her, we were all camping and I tripped her up, making her fall into some ropes. And when she said I did it, I just cried and said I didn't. You literally, that's like the Pitch Perfect 2, I think, where they go to the camp and they like get stuck in the bear trap. Wait, you literally Pitch Perfect 2'd your cousin. That's kind of cool. I think that's awesome. That's Akka awesome. Can we bring back saying Akka in front of everything? Please. Like, just for me. Just do it for me. Akka, awkward. When I was little, 5 or 6, I used to pick my nose at school and stick it on the carpet. I did it once, so I don't think anyone saw it. Ew. Dude, like, kids picking their nose, like, is actually the grossest thing ever. But, like, I feel like everyone did it at some point in their life. And that's, like, that's what makes it more gross, is that it's, like, a human instinct, and you have to be taught to not do it. That's nasty. Akka, you? No, literally. Why is everyone spelling Akka weird? Akka, what is that? Have none of you seen Pitch Perfect? Is it Akka or Akka? It's Akka like acapella. Akka. I'm not like old, am I? Like, you guys literally make me ew. I hate like feeling like an adult. Stop it. Stop. You know what Pitch Perfect is. I think you guys just get confused sometimes, and that's okay. When I was in 8th grade, we watched the Outsiders movie, and we started to get to the part where Johnny died, and I'm being so serious when I say I started uncontrollably sobbing. My teacher had to pause the movie in front of the whole 8th grade, and I got sent to the guidance counselor's office. The guidance counselors at school are a joke. They're like, you're being bullied? Oh. Oh. They're like, oh, wait. I think that, like, guidance counselors at school, I mean, like, okay, that's a generalization. Maybe there are good guidance counselors out there, but in my experience, it feels like guidance counselors are, they constantly overstep their boundaries. Not only that, but also it just seems like they signed up for the job so that they could participate in drama because they missed out on school drama in school, or they like didn't get enough of it, apparently. My guidance counselor talked to me about my problem, said she wouldn't say anything to anyone. The next day, all my teachers knew. No, because these teachers gossip and they send out mass emails too. Tired of it. It's messed up. Guidance counselor's only solution is to call your parents. No, you can't trust them with anything. Anything at all. I went trick-or-treating with my friends and we went up to this one guy's door and he said he had to sing for candy, so my friends and I sang the entire Pitch Perfect riff off to them. That's awesome. It's like the mean girls that say they want to be therapists. Yeah. That actually is kind of true. It's like they consistently made me feel worse about myself in high school, but they're going into a job to make other people feel better. Really? I stole my brother's sword and accidentally broke it and convinced him that he broke it and I got away with it. Gaslighting sometimes does solve problems, and I'll stand by that. Okay, speaking of standbying something, we're going to have a little standby. I'm going to put on some elevator music. I need to tie something out to someone. Hold on.
Just wait.
I did it. Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did. Do you guys want to move on from confessions? But, like, what do you want to do if we don't do confessions? You guys really want Rebecca? Hi, Juniper. Hello. Hi, 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 hi. Darman videos? I can't do Darman. I can't. Rebecca, TBH Roblox? I actually thought about Roblox. I'll play Roblox if I can get some friends to play with me. Rabbit hole of YouTube? Ooh. Ooh. Middle ground. Please find some friends to play. No, don't worry. DMs are sent. Roblox game called LGBTQ plus vibe best. Okay, let's just chat for a bit. Let's chat for a bit and we'll feel out the vibe, okay? This is gonna be like a... this is gonna be a FaceTime. OMG, this... the title's gonna be OMG, this literally feels like a FaceTime. With a bunch of exclamation points. Yeah? Really feeling the parasocial relationship with this one. Yeah, that's the vibe. Okay, let me close out of all these tabs because they're literally taking up all of my life. I want you to ruin my life, you to ruin my life, you to ruin my life, yeah. I haven't like done anything in the past like month, so I don't know what to talk about. let's chat. What are you guys up to? I had a midterm today. Midterms are gross because they feel like there's so much pressure on them. Also, piece I want to buy merch, but I'm too broke. Is there merch still out? Like, still for sale? Me not knowing my own merch. Wait, is there merch still for sale right now? Is my merch still, like, on? Oh. Yeah. Okay, real. I'm about to go play a little piano. Okay, awesome. Wait, do you guys play instruments? Why does my... did my camera get, like, really orange for you guys? Did my face get orange-ish? Or is it my monitor? Peace will say yes if I should get merch? Yeah. I think it might be my monitor. I think it does this at like 9. Wait, what's that? Oh, I just pressed a random button. Wait. Ah! I'm being hacked. Did my face get like really white or yellow? I'm so confused on what's going on right now. Is my vision, like... I don't know what's going on. It didn't happen? Wait, is my face not, like, orange right now? Guys, is my vision crazy? Like... guys. I'm scared. Guys, I'm a little scared. Check your display settings. That's what I'm kind of snooping on. OMG, you should play Drama Island on Roblox with chat. Yeah. Yeah. Are you colorblind? No. I don't think so. Pisu, you should do Omegle. You can't do that on Twitch, unfortunately. Oh, I want to talk to you guys about, like, what YouTube might look like. Okay. Here we go. This is a little list I came up with today. This is really good. This is a really good list, okay? Wait, I'm going to look at my stream on my phone, because I don't know if I'm... I think my eyes are, like, playing tricks on me. Which is kind of cute. Oh, I look cute. Okay. I look cute. You should do doors. I would do doors, but I feel like Roblox doors is so overdone. Low-key. Low-key, high-key. I'm going to start a series on TikTok where I prank call people's exes. So if you have a night mode on your PC, then it could be that. Let me check that. Night light. At 9 p.m. Wait, okay. Strength. Ah! Turn off now. Okay, that fixed it. That fixed it. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Why does Windows think I need a night light? Doors is so boring. Doors is low-key fun because of the music. Doors is only fun because of the music. Did you guys see Heidi Klum's worm costume? I thought that was kind of cute. I want to go as a little fish. And then, like, I want to go to... Oh my gosh. For Halloween next year, I'm going to go as a fish. And then I'm going to go to a frat party. Just so... I think the orange is supposed to help with blue light hurting your eyeballs. I don't care. It can hurt my eyeballs all at once. Okay, I'm gonna go as a fish, and then I'm gonna go to a frat party so all the boys will hold me. Cause you know how those frat boys feel about holding fish. They'd hold me up by my little feet like this and take a little photo. For their Instagram. It's the only way that I'll be held by a man. Anyways, that's my next Halloween costume next year, so that'll be awesome. Can't wait for that. That's nice, Piso. I'm glad you're supportive of me. Thank you. That's not very wholesome and baby. I think it's both wholesome and maybe even baby, if I do say so myself. Okay, oh my gosh. There's so many demons in my mind. I need to break free. It's actually kind of wholesomeness and Baba. No, for real. For real. How do you survive your senior year? I'm dying. My junior year was my senior year. Not really. But, like, my junior year is where I had a heavy workload. All I did was, like, procrastinate everything and then do it the night before. There's my advice for you. OMG, the demons. So maybe I'm colorblind, but I'll never know because I've never been anyone but me, so I don't know what real colors look like. Oh, I know what you mean by that. You're so right. Because my blue could be different from your blue, and your green could be different from my green. But also, our sensations of, like, the way that I feel and, like, the way that I experience, like, the way that pain feels for me could feel different for you. It could feel like being tickled for you. And the way that... Does that make any sense at all? What am I saying? Okay, yeah, I said blue and green. Good one. Good one, chat. Good one. That always hurts my head. Yeah. We could all be colorblind and the colorblind people aren't. Wait, you're so right. What? Makes no sense, but everyone else I've talked to about it says no. Okay. You're a furry? All right, thanks for letting me know, Max. Thank you. Furries are valid. Furries are awesome. Furries are salad. Furry like possum.
That was a poem that I just wrote. Furries are awesome. Furries are valid. Furries like salad. Furries are possum. Wait, furries are possum. Furries like salad. Write it down. It's already engraved in my brain forever. I wish I could engrave things on my brain. Is there a surgery for that? Sorry you guys have ads right now. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm the worst ever. I'm the worst. When is Maximum Girlfriend Piso's version? I think I'm gonna post like actual, like, I think I'm gonna post my music to be able to be like streamed on my Patreon, but it's gonna be like a tier 3 thing. So that's kind of just for the people who really go the extra mile, but I figured it's a good little benefit. Writing it in a notebook. Awesome. So what's your personal opinion on burnt toast? It like smells so bad, dude. It smells so bad. Alexi Galaxy, thank you so much for the... Oh, my Alexa went off. Alexi Galaxy, thank you so much for the sub. What a cool name. Thank you for the Prime. Can I tag you on TikTok to show you... Oh, I didn't get to finish your message. Sorry, you were cut off. Don't self-promo in chat. Real. I like your pin on your mic. Thank you. I don't know. Some liberal gave it to me. I'm just kidding. I'm the liberal. cut off like Pitch Perfect riff off. Get it? No, that was the same vibe. I already told you guys that. That I went to like a Pitch Perfect party, kind of. Where it was like they were all like at a little riff off. What's your opinion on bagels? Dude, like, I think they're amazing and I have them every day. Like, genuinely every single day I eat a bagel. Is that an issue? Is that something I should be concerned about? Also, something I've never, like, understood. Why is there a hole in the middle of the bagel? What's that for? Like, you're trying to rob me of bagel surface area. And donuts. What's your favorite thing to have for breakfast? Bagels, definitely. Parts of the year bagel tastes good, but other parts it tastes like rubber. It just depends on the kind of bagels you're getting. I'm eating a beagle. I'm eating a beagle right now. You're what? Uh-oh, that's problematic. Don't you dare touch doggo. No, that's like derp. Whose dog you munching on? How do you make the transition from high schooler to regular member of society? It's not a seamless, I don't understand. Like, genuinely, how am I supposed to take what they gave me in high school and then just become a real person? That, like, how are you supposed to socialize outside of high school? Or how are you supposed to, like, graduate and then, like, go somewhere else and then freaking... Oh, how am I supposed to make friends? How do people make friends that aren't... if you're not in high school? Because if I move out, where am I gonna... I mean, I'm moving closer to Florida, but not that close. So, like, my friends in Florida will, like, be there so I can, like, do a little driving. But, wait, you have to become a real person? No, you literally do. I'm dyslexic, OMG. I was the person that said I was eating beagles, but I meant to say I was eating a bagel. Okay, I get you. You're good. Right? Like, I don't... go outside. How am I supposed to meet people? No, genuinely. And it's like, it's actually, you become a streamer. This isn't a real job. Oh, you said at your job and stuff. that's the issue, is I'm supposed to be meeting people in my life, like at my job, but what job? How am I gonna meet IRL people in this job? It's like actually scary. GNS footprint, I've seen your message plenty of times. Boo, did I scare you? Richard, you got me. I can't lie, I was spooked. My anxiety doesn't allow me to meet people. I let people meet me and then run away from them. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Piso, you're so funny on Twitter. Thank you. I don't know what else to, I don't know what else to say to that. I think I'm okay. This is like a genuine, wait, can we like get into real talk? Cause like, I feel like all of the people who are just here to have their forms read, I always get really scared that people aren't going to like be interested in like the boring things that I have to say about my life. But like genuinely, like, I like don't know where. Like, I think that, like, graduating has, like killed Piso 4. And I don't know where he went. And I don't know how to get him back. That was so dramatic. That's the beginning to my Hannah Montana movie. But... no. But, like, I don't know, like, how to... It's because I'm not going out and I'm not experiencing things and I'm not like meeting new people. And also content creation has become so lukewarm because, and lukewarm was my nickname in high school because, I didn't even have one for that. See, like Piso 4 would have had that, but he's not here. Piso 4 is still awesome. Piso 4 is dead. Maybe I should do a rebrand. Nope. Absolutely not. Basically, sorry, I'm changing my lighting. Basically, I think that the transition from like going to like going from a high schooler to like not having a real job. Also, the thing is, I live with my parents right now. I have already had my blow up phase. I've already had my growth phase. I can do that all again. I can blow up. I can grow up. I can glow up. I can show up. I can stow up. But like, I can, like, have another blow up and stuff like that. But the thing is, like, that was my motivation before. Was, like, okay, I need to become, a notable content creator. Like, I need to get a community. And now that I have a community, I, like, don't have any motivation to, like, challenge myself creatively. And that's why I want to move out so bad. Is because I am literally going to be taking the biggest risk I've ever taken. I just spit on my lip. And if you saw that, I am so sorry. I'm going to be taking the biggest risk that I've ever taken in my whole life because I'm going to graduate and then because I graduated and then I'm going to move out to an apartment where I have bills that I have to pay for. I have bills, I have rent, I have taxes, I have all of this different stuff that I did not learn in school, and I'm going to have to figure out how to do that. But also, having actual bills to pay will like make me actually have to make content and actually have to like grow my channel and succeed. You know what I'm saying? Because I feel like if I'm not challenging my brain, it's really hard for me to grow creatively. And right now, I've gotten in this place where I feel comfortable, and I feel too comfortable, and I feel almost bored with what I'm doing. And for some reason, I don't have the motivation or the focus to get out of it. And the only way to do that is to be like, okay, you need to post on YouTube or you are literally going to get evicted from your home. So, the Piso 4 community is going to get really interesting because it's literally going to be, like, more high stakes. Because it's like, oh, this man needs to do something with his life. But, like, does that make sense? Does that all make sense? I genuinely feel like because that, like, that stress and that lukewarm kind of feeling and the feeling of, like, not being challenged and not having to, like, grow or push myself out there or make new things or do new stuff, all of that stuff has made me like it makes me just like in the back of my mind I'm always worried or I'm always like disappointed in myself or have a lot of like self-doubt or lack a lot of like self-confidence, you know.
And I think about it like during my like during the entirety of my streams. Then I end stream and I go lay in my bed and I silently scroll on my phone because I'm like, okay, I need to like get my mind off of stream. And I really want to help you, but I don't know how. I don't know. This isn't like something, I'm not doing this for like attention or sympathy or like for people to like help me or like, you know, stick around and stuff like that. I'm saying this because like, I like being transparent with you guys. Where was I? I don't know. I think that like thought in the back of my mind of like, I feel like I'm not, like my lack of confidence is making me worse at what I do. And then me being worse at what I do is making me lack confidence. He's so transparent. Where'd he go? No! No! Wait, maybe I could enter my Taylor Swift reputation era. Will you be making the Patreon? I will. And like, I never understood why like content creators had issues. I was like, no, this is like fun. Like, this is the best thing in the world. Like, all you have to do is like make, all you have to do is make content. And then I like, and now I'm here and I'm like, wait, this is like the most not okay that I've been in a long time. There, I said it. Whew. I'm gonna have to repeat this all to my therapist tomorrow. You should rebrand it Taylor Swift. Yeah. The era joke always makes me laugh. Yeah, I'm glad. Thank you. Recurring jokes. Also, it's just so hard to like be a just chatting streamer. Like, I've done every single Google form that you could ever do. I mean, really? What's your most embarrassing school story? Come on. Now what? Just show your therapist the VOD? I'll sleep in tomorrow and send the VOD over. Piso Valorant era? Ew, no. Piso, you mean a lot to all of us. You've got this. I'm so proud of how far you've come. I'm so excited for the future content. You will get through this. I appreciate it. Thanks. It is just scary because it's like, all the little strangers on the internet can be like, yeah, Piso, like, you can do it. We're rooting for you. And, like, I'm like, yeah, like, this is fun. But then I, like, remember that the thing that I'm doing isn't, like, a game or, like, a competition. It's, like starting my life. It's, like the decisions that I make over the next few months are, like, set the trajectory of what my life is going to be. So can you start making edits of people live on stream? That'll be my stream. I'll have a Adobe After Effects open, and I'll stream me doing live edits. But I really want to make a lot. I think YouTube is a good next move for me once I figure out what to do over there. But yeah, it genuinely is just like I'm at the scariest time of my entire life. Also, growing up on the internet, like being at like huge phases like of your life, like having those being documented on the internet is just like so scary as well, because it's like if I fail, like not only do you guys all watch that, but so does like everyone at home, everyone who talks about me in my hometown, everyone who saw me blow up, everyone who gossips about me, everyone who doesn't like me or doesn't like that I told that story on my TikTok and wants me to fail. I mean, like, it just feels like I feel like I'm still a kid being watched. Like, I feel like I'm still a kid in my brain. And I'm being watched as I go through all the awkward and hard phases of my life. I love your pajama pants. They look comfy. They are very comfy. Pronouns, please. He, they. Maybe you should fake a downfall for the views. Ooh. Wait, what? How would people watch that? I'm like, yeah, I failed. Is that the video? Let's beef? Wait, that's low-key what I should do. I should just start beef with, like, who's, like, a C-list celebrity that I could start beef with? That would, like, listen to me.
You should make diss tracks of your friends. Funny ones, though. Real. I don't know. Start crying on stream and throw some stuff around your room. Okay, if you're a real one, do you want to see a photo that I'm probably going to post on Twitter tomorrow? Because you're a real one and you stayed. You stayed for the trauma dumping. I'm just going to show it for a little quick sec. But it kind of goes so hard because we're like matching in the photo. And it like... And we're like all posed up. Look at that. That's PogChamp. Banger pick. No, literally. Literally the best pick ever taken. Please, Piso. I'm not real. Don't say I'm real. That's parasocial. You're right. That is parasocial. When is that being posted? I don't know. Probably tomorrow. I think. Is that one of Hannah's films pick? Film picks? Yeah. Yep. Hear me out, chat. What if I use the guest star feature? The Piso 4 Instagram community is dying. I need more Instagram pictures because I don't have Twitter. I do need to post more on Instagram. I'm posting that. I think I'm going to post that on Instagram. Have you guys seen the guest? Do you guys know what the guest star feature is? It's basically like I can bring viewers up as like a FaceTime kind of thing. I think that that could be super fun. And I think that there could be like a new meta there. Because if you didn't know, like, I did popularize the Google Form meta on TikTok or on Twitch, which is a real fact, by the way. And I will never let that go. And I will keep bringing it up for the rest of my life because I made history on Twitch. And if you've ever seen one of your faves do a little Google Form stream, you have me to thank. Because I was the... Sorry, I'm like going to talk on myself a little bit too much. But I think what I need to do is... I need to re-revolutionize the just chatting category. I think that I need to take guest. I think I need to take guest star, the feature. I also want to go live on TikTok so bad, but they just won't unban me. It literally makes me so mad. Like, because TikTok's support system is not even like an app has a bad support system. It keeps people from doing their jobs. Getting restrictions on my account means I literally don't make as much money. That happens to other creators as well. Like, I literally got banned on TikTok Live for doing absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. I've gone live on TikTok once and they said I was underage. Get over yourself. And I submitted an appeal. They denied my appeal. I'm permanently banned. I tweeted them at least like 4 times a month. And I have been for the past year. Like, I want to do talent shows because I feel like if I hosted talent shows, what if you made like a game show kind of thing with the guest star? That's kind of what I'm thinking. I'm being for real about that. Like, I thought about game show. It's just... The thing, Mag, like, genuinely, and I guess all of chat, I don't know why I'm just speaking to Mag, but, the reason why, like, I'll have ideas like that, where I'm like, wait, I could do, like, game shows with chatters, and they can get on it, and, like, I'll come up with all this stuff, and then it requires work, and because there's nothing pushing me to do the work, because I can just sit at home all day and scroll through TikTok, or have my brain be stimulated, because I don't absolutely have to write down details to a game show on a Google Doc. I just don't. And I don't know what kind of thing is going to give me the motivation or like make me fall in love with the creative process again. But I think that I need something new to challenge my creative brain. Because I've been doing this for like almost 2 years now. Like, I've been sitting in this chair streaming for almost 2 years now. Like, that will burn out a person. 2 years with no changes. No reason to, like... I need a landlord knocking on my door telling me that he's gonna take away my
house. I need that. You've been sitting in a chair for 2 years straight? That's gotta be a real comfy chair. That's the thing, is this chair sucks. This chair actually hurts. How would the guest star be moderated? I think Discord mods or Twitch mods can moderate it. Also, if someone does something that's bannable, they get banned. I don't. Just explore the options, have a long think about what is important to you. You want to know something funny? I don't give my little brain one single second of a break to think, ever. I'm like, I need constant stimulation. I'm like, I need music playing in the background while I'm putting away the dishes, and I need a podcast while I'm in the shower, and I need a TikTok while I'm in the blah, 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 blah. No, I want to throw my phone in the river. I want to light every single social media app on fire. I'm tired of it. And I know you all are too. What podcasts do you listen to? Ooh, I listen to Emergency Intercom. I started listening to Violating Community Guidelines because Emergency Intercom's on a break right now. But I liked Violating Community Guidelines a lot. I like Brittany Broski. Take a Benadryl. That will slow things down. Yeah. Little horse tranquilizer never hurt. That's a joke. It did. It does. I say that like I have been doing that. I feel like I've been on social media for so long and it's becoming unmotivated. I think we're getting to the point in our lives where we're all tired of social media. Finally. Like, took us long enough. And social media apps are becoming less and less profitable as the years go on. Because, like, okay. Here's a little deal for you. Oh, my stomach is about to growl. Why am I hungry? I just ate. I eat all the time. Okay. When social media apps first started coming out, it was just like the first thing that they were pushing was like, you need to share your life, you need to share everything out here, you need to document it, blah 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 blah. That was the way that they got everyone hooked. Then they were like, okay, they got people addicted, and they were like, you need us, you need social media, you need social media to like stay up to date, you need it to stay in touch with your friends, you need it to be up to date with like current news events, you need it to laugh and to record things and to post things and share, blah blah blah. Now we're getting to the point where, but in reality, they've tricked us into thinking that we need social media, when social media and the platforms need us. And the less of us that they have, the less money that they're making. And that's what started to happen over the past few years. I think that Bo Burnham said all of that, and I just repeated it. Now I'm turning 30! Like Bo Burnham really did turn 30. You ate? Thank you. Creds to Bo, I think. I don't know. Even the people who have created social media are tired of it and say it's dangerous. They won't let their kids use the apps they made. The social dilemma just shows how scary and toxic it is. Toxic it is. That's the thing. And also, the way that social media works right now is they want, like, okay, I watched an interview with Mr. Beast like a while ago, and it was like Mr. Beast was like, you have to give them a reason to keep a reminder to keep watching. Like, you have to give them a reason to keep watching the content every 30 seconds. They need to find a new reason to keep watching. I think that's what the quote was. Maybe it was a different time, but like 30 seconds. That's crazy. that were like intentionally putting things to make videos addicting or engaging or constantly turning cuts away and like stuff like that. Also, like cartoons now, cartoons like switch frames like four times more than they used to. Like they switch back and forth from like cameras and stuff like that, like children's shows, because that's the only way that they can keep the kids engaged. Like people, like attention in like this overly saturated entertainment market that the world is right now, attention equals money, and people have found out how to play the game in order to get attention, in order to get people's attention. And sometimes I even play that game, but it feels like the only way, like it feels like I can't be a genuine person and get people to watch me on the internet. It feels like I need to do something crazy, or I need to have some kind of hook, or I need to have some kind of engagement, or I need to have subtitles on the screen one word at a time that takes me an hour and a half so that people will watch the video the whole time. Ugh. Peaceful, if you listen to Carly Rae Jepsen, I love Carly Rae Jepsen. Children's content right now is kind of a fever dream. You want to see? Okay, yeah, we're doing it. We're watching Rebecca Zamolo. I want to do, maybe I should make a video on this. If I was more articulate, I could do videos like off the top of my head, but I just genuinely like I'm not at a time in my life where like my brain doesn't work the same way that my mouth does. Or the same way that my mouth wants to. All right, let's look at this video. I have watched this entire video. Just to remind you guys, Honk Stella, thank you so much for the sub with Prime. Honk Stella, have I seen your name before? Like a long time ago? Hi, Honk Stella. I feel like I recognize your name somehow. Thank you for the sub. Sorry, not to call you out, but also, if this like conversation isn't interesting to you, sorry, this is not the PSO4 that is happy-go-lucky PSO4, but I'm sorry. The old PSO can't come to the phone right now. Okay. Why? Cause he's dead. Oh, look what you made me do. Tessa, thank you for the raid. All right, let's look at this video that is called My Daughter Crawls for the First Time Emotional. All right, and if I release, first of all, look at this thumbnail. Wait, she had a kid? I guess so. I don't know much about her. Are you going to the Eras tour? Yeah, I think so. I think I'm gonna go in Florida, I think. And you know what that means. I'll keep my mouth shut. Shh. All I'm gonna say is God bless Capital One. Okay. So my daughter crawls for the first time. Go with your friends, please. Oh, I have some plans in the making. I'm so excited for Taylor's tour. All right. Okay, guys, my goal is to be financially stable by April of next year. Okay. So basically, I watched this entire video. Also, if you see me release a YouTube video about this exact video and I say some of the same commentary that I said right now, then I'm sorry. I just get over it, you know? But we're going to watch this. You would think that without the thumbnail, my daughter crawls for the first time emotional. What do you think the thumbnail would be? Like her crying or her like really happy that her daughter is crawling? No, it's like... like they both look like emotes. How did you turn your one-year-old daughter into an emote? Let's watch this. I'm gonna need to extend. All right, I have watched 17 minutes of this video, but I keep watching videos on YouTube today and being like, it's research for when I upload on YouTube, but like we all know I'm secretly enjoying watching Rebecca Zamolo. That's actually not true. This is the craziest thing. All right, this video is gonna blow your mind, and I'm excited for us to experience it together. All right. My daughter crawls for the first time emotional.
Okay, ZD.
Oh, that is the worst quality.
Okay, ZD.
Okay, I want to preface this by saying her daughter's name is Zadie. And her daughter's last name is Zamolo. Zadie Zamolo. Do I have a southern accent? No. I think sometimes. Hopefully, because that's like kind of cute. That's like a cute little quirk of mine. Oh, you guys had an ad right when I started the video. I'm sorry. All right, I'm sorry. Okay, well, we're 1 second in the video. I'll just wait for the people to get back from the ads. But if anyone wants to get us a sub goal, I'll do a little dance. I thought she said ZD, like the noodle. My baked little ZD. Mm-hmm. When they say you have a bun in the oven, but really you have ZD in the oven. All right, this girl's name, her name is Zadie Zamolo.
Okay, ZD, here you go. Stay right here. Mom has to do laundry. Be back.
Okay. I'm glad she put up that graphic for me because I was like, wait, what's laundry? Why does chat act like every single ad is the first ad they've ever seen? That's so real. You're so real for saying that. Hi, Eli Plays. Zadie Zamolo. Okay, last in alphabetical order every single time. Oh my gosh, you just made a point that I didn't even think about. Wait, write that down for my YouTube video. Put that in the Clips and Idea channel. I'll credit you. Maybe. Okay. Hey. All right, she's doing her laundry.
Hello?
And she gets a phone call.
I just saw some movement in the backyard. Is everything okay there?
Yeah, I'm just doing laundry. I'll call you back. Zadie? Zadie? Oh no. Zadie? How'd she get up? Zadie?
The cat is so confused.
She's okay.
Oh my gosh. Did you do this?
Yes. Zadie's going to be crawling any day now and you need to be ready.
No. I'm not ready for her.
Oh, okay. Husband pranks his wife that the daughter is drowning challenge. The picture. Yo, what kind of game theory is this? Why is she pretending? It's so dramatic. It's so good. You know this is so good, dude. This is my favorite. I genuinely will literally, like, I love watching these videos so much. So much. Okay.
Her to crawl, things could fall on her. She could fall down the stairs or even worse, fall in the pool like that.
Why would they animate her falling down the stairs?
Baby.
Rebecca, this moment's coming, whether you like it or not.
What? Sadie? My daughter Zadie is growing up so fast and she's gonna be crawling any day now. I don't think I'm ready for her to take this next step because once Zadie starts moving, it's gonna be harder and harder to keep her safe. But my husband Matt has a 4-step program that will help train Zadie to keep her safe when crawling and help me overcome my fear. And at the end of this, I'm gonna get to watch my daughter Zadie crawl for the first time.
I hope their editor gets a really good check.
There are 4 levels. Each level will help Zadie learn how to crawl and you to overcome your fear. But Rebecca, your challenges are going to be extreme.
So Rebecca has to do challenges too.
Level 1 is all about trust.
Me acting like I've never seen the video before. I actually don't remember it because I think I fell asleep to it.
The trust that Zadie is going to be okay.
Well, I think...
Like, I did not remember the baby drowning in the pool. That was a big surprise. This is like a game show? No, literally. Imagine them going back and being like, so, like, what were Zadie, you know, in the future is going to be like, so what was it like when I took my first steps? They're like, oh, well, your dad tricked me first that you drowned. And then we went through a 4-level extreme challenge.
She'll be okay.
Edited with your face.
No, Rebecca, let's put her on the floor.
Wait, should I change title? What should the title be? Give me title suggestions, chat.
Well, Zadie has done a ton of tummy time. Look at that.
These toys are going to help her to learn how to crawl. I'm going to warn you. She's going to fall a little bit.
Okay.
Here.
Whoa.
You have to let her do it. Here you go. You got it, okay. Zadie. There you go. Oh. See, she fell a little bit. She's fine. Don't catch her, though. Let her fall.
Okay.
Don't catch her. Don't let your baby hit her head. Rebecca Zamolo Extreme Reaction Challenge. My daughter crawls for the first time.
emotional. I am naming my stream that. That is so funny. That is so funny. Watching mom monetize her toddler. No, yeah, that's also something we need to talk about, is how messed up that, like, that these kids are just actors to them in these videos. Guys, watching Rebecca struggle to everything. Watching videos of me as a baby. Watching home videos of my mom teaching me how to crawl. Should I call it my daughter crawls for the first time emotional? I don't know. What do you think, chat? What's a good title?
Her head.
Rebecca.
I'm just making sure she has a soft little landing.
She's totally fine. It's carpet.
I think she's more
comfortable. Oh! Because I was like, wait, what did he say? But they put it on the screen and zoomed in and said carpet. Like, this is exhausting. They are competing for these kids' attentions.
No.
Yeah.
You have to let Zadie do this, okay? Okay, Zadie, go get that cup. And don't worry about falling. You got this. Rebecca, don't worry.
Yeah, don't worry about falling, no, 1-year-old who can't crawl.
See? She's okay.
Okay. Well,
did she teleport there?
Don't worry about Zadie
falling. No, I trust.
Trust her. See?
See? She's okay. You know? You can teach a baby how to crawl, but you can't teach a baby how to teleport. Is that even a toy? It just looks like a metal cup. Yeah, why do they have the communion cups out?
She's okay!
Okay, well,
No.
Watching 1-year-old teleport. Yeah, she's gonna fall when she's actually pressed to the ground. Rebecca's so paranoid, I feel so bad. I think she's definitely playing it up for the character, but also this dynamic is not a cute thing to play up. This isn't a cute little, like, oh, dad wants to push the 1-year-old baby to its limits and mom doesn't want the baby to, and mom wants the baby to be safe. Like, that's not a funny little dynamic that's keeping me interested. Like, I feel like you guys need to go to marriage counseling.
I got you. I just don't want her to get hurt. Okay.
There you go, Zadie.
Okay. Oh.
She's okay. Look at her face.
Good girl, Zadie.
Yay.
You really think that she's going to be able to crawl for the first time at the end of today?
If she follows my 4-step program, this is going to work. But Rebecca, it's time for you. It's about to get extreme.
Later, Zadie's going to be meeting up.
Mirror, mirror on the wall.
With another YouTube family that has...
Later, Zadie's gonna be meeting up with another YouTube family. Oh my gosh.
As a baby, who do you think it is?
This is the trust fall challenge. In order to get over your fear of Zadie falling, you need to fall and trust that you're gonna be okay.
But I'm falling back.
Oh, does Matt have a psychology degree? Because he is really making some points here. Yo, in order for you to feel okay with your baby, you need to not be able to fall. Sorry, I got on my phone.
Backwards on a balcony!
We're gonna be doing YouTube trivia. Every time that you get it wrong, I'm gonna be cutting a rope.
What?
You only have 3 ropes, so you do the math.
Zambam, before I lean back, make sure that you are subscribed. Let's see if we can hit 14 million by the end of the year.
Okay, we're good.
Comment, goal squad! If you do all that, and turn on notifications and click all! Oh, oh my gosh.
It's not that safe, I'll be honest.
Yeah.
I did these knots myself.
Let's just get this over with.
Question number one. Which YouTuber has 2 children and one of them has their own YouTube channel?
Actually, that could be multiple. I'm gonna go with Jordan Matter because Hudson has a...
Okay, something that I want to mention is that all of these YouTube channels are connected. Like, they're all interconnected in this, like, they're all owned by this one person. And all of these 14 million, yeah, these videos do wonders. And her channel grows so fast. All of these channels do. All these channels do. I really liked Rebecca and Matt because they didn't have kids to exploit. but all these channels do is they treat their family members and their kids like characters. And no way these kids are seeing any of that money. It's messed up, and these kids just need a normal childhood. Like, imagine going to school after you...
Channel!
Correct. What is Sniper Wolf's real name?
Leah! Leah is her name. Leah! I know her. I'm friends with her.
You're right.
That checks out.
It feels very scary. This is a huge drop from the top of my balcony.
How many YouTubers exist?
That's impossible. I don't know, maybe like 10,000.
Yeah, great question, Matt. Hey, Manta Ray, I guess. Thank you so much for the sub. Wait, where are my notifs? Yo, where's my alert box? Where are my alerts? There we go. Thank you so much for the sub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And then where's my sub goal? Oh, it's bottom right. Okay. She guessed 10,000. Guys, how many YouTubers do you think there are? It's like putting your kid into acting at a young age. Yeah, except like instead of like one movie or like a TV series, it's like a camera shoved in your face in the privacy of your own home and your parents are pressuring you to do it 24/7. Like,
What YouTube family calls out their daughter's name every single time that they do an episode?
On a Soul Family, they call out Mila! Mila!
Mila!
Mila!
Mila!
Oh, it's funny because they're being loud. Wait, because for a second I was like, wait, I don't get the bit. But then, like, when they shook the camera around, when they screamed Mila, like, it was funny. Hi, Kiki. By the way, they didn't have kids before because they couldn't, and before this baby, she had a miscarriage. Oh, I did not know all of that information. Space, thank you so much for the sub. Thank you for the resub. Mwahaha. Then I apologize for saying that I'm glad they didn't have kids. I just didn't want their kids to be born and then exploited on YouTube for views. But...
You're right. Correct.
Correct.
What YouTube family is expecting the third child?
Wait. Royalty family. Please don't cut that. Please don't cut that.
I don't know what, because like, is this safe? Like, what if she fell? What if she hit her head?
You're correct. How many daughters do the LeBron family have?
They have three now. They just had Sunday. Everly, Posey, and Sunday. And
also, that was not a grammatically correct sandwich sentence. That was not a grammatically correct sandwich. How many daughters do the Labyrinth family have?
They have three now. They just had Sunday. Everly, Posey, and Sunday. They also have
Okay, I'm skipping this. She just needs to fall already.
Phase rep, Brian! Please do not cut the left.
You're right. What YouTuber was the first to 10 million subscribers?
I don't know, Mr. Beast.
Pretty close.
It's
Mr. Beast Espanol.
What?
I'm
sorry, Rebecca. What? Mr. Beast Spanish channel was the first YouTube channel to hit 10 million. It is a correct sentence, Piso.
Which face plan? Already passed.
Maybe I just read it wrong, or maybe I'm tired. How many daughters does the Labyrinth family have? No, I'm right. It should be does, not do. It's do? No, it's does. Because then if you rearrange it, if you take the question and you turn it into a sentence, the Labyrinth family does have blank amount of daughters. It's do? I'm right. I'm right, and I'll die on this hill. Because the way that you can check your grammar is by taking the question and turning it into a statement. The reason why it's tripping you guys up, and the reason why it's tricking you, it tricked them up as well, is because you're seeing daughters, and so you're thinking daughters do. But the subject of the sentence is actually about, it's about the Labyrinth family. Labyrinth family have. Does have. Labyrinth family does have. But because it's a question... Because if it's a question, it's reformatted in a way that's really tricky. Labyrinth? PC, you should be an English teacher? Okay, yeah. They does? The Labyrinth family does have two daughters. The Labyrinth family do have two daughters. It's both TBH? It's not. It's not both. By the way, it's not both, so I'm right. But the Labyrinth family is more than one person, but they're a group of people. It's like saying like a group, so the group is like one entity. If you had multiple families, that would be different. It's a singular entity, thank you. It is both? No. No, it's not. I did, like, this is all I learned sophomore year. Piso was right, y'all. I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell them either, because I even reformatted the question as a sentence. The YouTube channel's name is The Labyrinth Family, so it is both. What does the word the have to do? It definitely does. How many daughters does the Labyrinth family have? That makes sense. How many daughters does the Labyrinth family have? Anyway. Piso hates on and attacks uneducated fans. Real. Sorry, I'm really passionate about subject-verb agreement. I'm literally British. We made the language. Yeah, what else did you make, Charlie? Go ahead and name the other awesome things that British people do. All right, I'm gonna move on past this grammar lesson.
Pizza party once he hits 10 million subscribers. It's Eric. You're getting full. It's 10 million subscribers, Becca.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
Wait, I googled it. Does is right, but it can be both. Night is very gay. I'm not arguing with you on this one. IDK, we made custard's cream. We made custard's creams. Ew.
What's terrible? I can't believe I lost that challenge.
But you took a giant fall, right?
Yeah, I did because I lost.
Did you get hurt?
No.
And my point exactly. Level one complete. This is
what point did he make? That if Zadie the baby were up there, she wouldn't have gotten hurt? Does he know that a baby is not the same as a grown woman? Who's gonna tell Matt? Wait, did I change the title? My daughter crawls for the first time. Emotional. Okay, I just changed the title.
This is level two, and we are here at my gym.
Zadie loves my gym.
I have a giant fear of things falling on Zadie.
Yeah?
Well, she's going to face that fear today, and then yours is going to be even more extreme back at the house.
I don't know if I want things falling on Zadie.
Trust me, Rebecca. Everything here is safe. You got this. Meet me on the floor.
What? I don't think that's a fear that she needs to overcome. I think that things falling onto your child, not even child, a baby, I think that is a valid concern to have. The internet was invented by a British person? Yeah, that checks out.
Do you think this is a good idea? Yeah, I don't think you should crawl yet either.
Everything is all set up on the obstacle course. She's gonna have to get through it without anything falling on her.
We learned that you be careful, don't let it knock on her. Okay, Zay, let's see if she can get to this, Sam Fam.
What are you doing, Matt? Matt, what are you doing? Thank you so much for the 2 gifted subs. Carls, that is awesome. That is amazing. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, Carls. Drake's in chat for Carls and some other just angry emote in chat or scared emote in chat for Zadie. Guys, what is Matt doing?
Well, don't let it knock on her. Okay, Zay, let's see if she can get to this, Sam Fam. Careful.
The sound effects. Careful.
She's fine.
I don't want this knocking her.
Good job, Zadie. There you go. Oh. Rebecca, this is soft. It's meant for kids.
I don't trust it.
There you go. You can't protect her forever, Rebecca.
Are you okay?
You can't protect her forever, Rebecca. You know, Rebecca, since she's 1 year old and I want her to be dependent or independent was the word I was looking for. Sorry, maybe I need the English lesson. She's so confused. OMG. Yeah, she's like, why is Dad trying to throw things on me?
It scared her. She got it. Whoa.
Rebecca, super soft.
Hey, it's
Rebecca, stop not letting me throw things on. I know it's a bit. I know it's for the script. I know it's for the video. And it's fun to pretend like it's not. But even if it's just for the video, even if these people are not actually like this, and he's obviously not actually trying to throw things onto the baby, it is such a bad example to set for kids. For kids with younger siblings, they might be like, "Oh, come on, little sibling. Now it's time to do the throw things on you challenge while you try to crawl."
As long as I can watch her at all times.
Look at, I'll hit you. It doesn't do anything. She's totally fine.
Come on,
Zadie. You got it, Zadie.
Okay, I think she did.
Also, why are all of her toys just shot glasses? Have I missed some baby lore? Or why do they keep having communion glasses? What is that supposed to be? Is that a menstrual cup? Get out.
I don't think I'm ever going to get used to things falling on Zadie, even if it is at a kid's place and it's totally safe.
She did great and she was safe, just like you said. But if you thought this was bad, your challenge is even more extreme. This is the Never Have I Ever Hydro Blaster, and it's about ready to get extreme.
No, see, her challenge isn't more extreme because she's not 1 year old. I think that trying to push things over onto your baby, I think that that's more extreme than popping a water balloon on a grown woman's head. That's my thought. Okay, you guys won't see much of her in this, but this is my favorite Rebecca Zamolo character. Anytime she talks directly to the camera, and she kind of bounces around like that, and it's the best thing ever.
Now it's time for Rebecca to have
seriously
fall on her
I love
head.
Her is... why do they keep popping up?
Seriously,
now it...
what is going on? Who edited this? Like, this is like part of the MCU, the way you know Rebecca Zamolo characters. I've watched like 4 videos maybe. Character lol. Yeah, I know it's a bit, and I need to remind myself that because I'm actually getting upset. Yeah, but like the kids don't know it's a bit, so like you're upset. Your upset feelings are valid.
It's time for Rebecca to have things fall on her head. This is Never Have I Ever.
And if you've done something, you have to pump 10 times.
Hey, Rebecca, we can hear you.
And if you drop something, you have to pump 10 times.
Things fall on her head. This is Never Have I Ever.
And if you've done something, you have to pump 10 times. Never have I ever been on a dating app.
Oh.
Oh.
Also, who built this for this video? This video, what was this video's budget? They post a lot, and their videos are pretty high production value.
Never have I ever been pregnant.
Not right, fair.
Four, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh!
Okay.
Never have I ever kissed a stuffed animal.
Rebecca did have a journey. Secret room under the bed video, you guys. Okay. What?
Huh? Hey, Rebecca, what was that? Hey, Rebecca. Hey, Rebecca, I have a little question. What were you doing there? Also, pairs of my friends, all of you said, Piso, you are such a good commentator. You're literally so funny. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to do, like, kind of commentary videos that, like, are chill and scripted or, like, a little bit roughly scripted. I just need things to do them on. If you find things that you think I could do a commentary video on, send it in my Discord. Send it in my Instagram DMs. Send it on Twitter, please, because I'm genuinely... I have been scouring the internet. Also, how do you spell the word scouring? Because I tried to use that word in a sentence the other day, but... Wait, what?
Never
have I ever kissed...
Never have I ever kissed a stuffed animal.
Rebecca did have a journey
Rebecca did it a giant sleepover with my daughter. First giant sleepover with my daughter. Did her daughter have to... Okay, thank you guys. I've just never seen that word written out before. Did her daughter have to, like, fill out a job application to be a part of this child? Or to be a part of this, like...
Room under the bed video, you guys. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Oh my gosh.
Nine.
Oh. The awkward part was that it was the same stuffed animal.
Never have I ever.
That is so awkward.
I have.
Oh, I have. Yeah, Matt, you seem like the type to go bungee jumping.
Ten.
I'm bored.
Not kiss someone in the GMN.
Matt, we're married. You.
Okay, so they start this narrative that these two have kissed each other. And I want you to look for all the clues. And anytime you see them,
Tell me that you've spotted a clue, like it's an episode of Dora or something. All right. Yeah, Rebecca's gone. Oh, man. Do you think they're homophobic? Wildly. but they keep it under wraps for the public image.
Oh, that was awesome.
Oh, that scared me so bad. I thought she was about to kill Matt. Dude, where did she find that so fast? No, she is not messing around. Well, she has to defend her baby, you know, from her husband who's been trying to throw things on it. Stupid water balloon. She like pulls out the knife.
Good try.
It's Pitch Burst. If you take longer than 3 seconds to answer a question, this happens. Hey, Matt, when's the last time you talked to your ex?
That was not 3 seconds, Rebecca.
That's how it works. Maddie, after you graduate, will you still continue to do YouTube? Maddie! After you graduate, will you still continue to do YouTube? Maddie!
Oh my gosh, this is me lying to my parents. Hey mods, could you explain someone or to the Nightmare on Elm what's going on? I told you she's my favorite.
What's your answer?
I don't have the answer, I just got Pitch Burst.
Damn. You were gone for a while. Who of the three of us did you miss the most?
I did miss bro time with Matt a lot.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah.
Oh. And look, chat, did you see who pressed that button and got a little bit angry that he was spending bro time with Matt? I found a clue.
Like bro time now, Daniel.
That was the best together.
Matt,
yeah.
Are you ready to be a dad of two?
Dad of two, like right now?
One, three.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Time, have you taken her back in the pool?
Yes. Stay with
Do you guys like this video? The thing is like sometimes I'll click on video like Rebecca Zamola videos because we'll be like, what bizarre stuff is she up to now? And can I make a YouTube video about it? And then because they've put something in these videos to activate my Cocomelon brain, I will sit there and like watch it and then be like, oh, I need to stop.
Happy doing when she controlled my life for 24 hours. Maddie, have you gone on a date in the last
week? I feel like this video's been going on for an hour. All of their videos are 20 minutes.
Yes.
Oh.
Hot chili pepper. Maddie went on a date? That's weird, right? Who do you love more, Z?
Hot chili pepper. Maddie went on a date? Well, hot chili pepper. I just want to ruthlessly judge them, even though I'm fully aware it's all staged and a joke. But they're still doing it. I mean, it's still their choice to do this staged. It's not even as a joke. Like, this is what they're thinking is entertainment. And, like, they think it's good quality content for children. Waffle, thank you so much for the sub with Prime. Is it camp? Ooh. Is Rebecca Zamolo camp? I don't think that Rebecca Zamolo is camp. Oh yeah, I forgot that we are watching a video about their baby crawling. What happened to that? I don't think that it's camp, but I think that the one girl is camp. Maddie, I think is her name.
Obviously, Zadie. She's my rainbow baby.
It's kind of hard not to love her.
Maddie, have you kissed anyone in the last week?
Wait, anyone, like not a step?
Like not? Like hurry up, Boris, get up! Daniel, when's the last-
She cry? Where does this link with the baby crawling? Because things are falling on them, and Rebecca needs to get over that. Remember?
Last time you hung out with Maddie.
This past week.
And what did you guys do?
This is like watching an episode of Riverdale, literally.
What?
No, oh.
Last week.
And what did you guys-
hung out with Maddie.
This past
last week.
And what did you guys do?
Well,
3, 2, 1.
Well, I mean, I.
But seriously, what did you guys do?
Answer that.
Who would you rather control your life for 24 hours?
Wait, what'd you guys do?
I don't have to answer that.
Okay.
Who would you rather control your life for 24 hours? Salish or for
okay,
long?
I'm bored.
Are you ready?
Disturbing. Second, 3 seconds! I'm not even gonna
told me about.
Oh, it's kinda weird.
Who's she dating?
I don't know, but you're breathing really heavy right now. It's kinda weird.
Where are we watching Rebecca Zamolo? I just joined because her baby learned how to crawl.
Are there any secrets that Maddie has told you that she has not told me about?
Yes, for obvious reasons.
Who's she dating?
I don't know, but you're breathing really heavy right now. It's kind of weird.
What are you most afraid?
At least she said it, so I didn't have to. I don't know, but you're breathing really heavy right now. It's kind of weird. Like, that was out of... She broke character there. Hold on, I want non-subs to see that as well. Can we get back to the baby? Yeah, after this. Okay, here.
I'm not even gonna ask about pictures of me.
Are there any secrets that Maddie has told you that she has not told me about?
Yes, for obvious reasons.
Who's she dating?
I don't know, but you're breathing really heavy right now. It's kind of weird.
What are you most afraid of when Zadie starts crawling?
What's wrong? Okay.
I'm realizing that it's not Zadie that can't crawl. It's me that's afraid, and I'm holding her back.
Hey, you know what? You don't have to go through with this if you don't want to. It's totally okay.
I have to do it. If Zadie's gonna crawl the first time, I've got to get over my fear.
Oh, yeah, it was longer than 3 seconds.
You still popped the balloon on her mat?
Get over it.
You still popped a balloon on her mat? I swear she reminds me of someone and I can't put my finger on it. Maybe it's me. This is me and my TikToks. Brynster, thank you for the gifted sub. Drake's in chat for Bryn. Thank you so much.
Crawl the first time. I've got to
the music came out of nowhere.
It's a challenge.
Rebecca can't crawl. Yeah, maybe they need to make a video on that.
Get over it. This is level 3, and we are back at my gym. But this time, we're joined by Chelsea, who's a child development specialist. Most importantly, she's going to help you overcome your fear of Zadie going down the stairs.
We got our special toys to help Zadie, to encourage her.
Okay.
We're going to start her over here.
You could not pay me any amount of money to talk in my YouTube voice in front of a stranger. Like, how did he just, like, speak like that in front of this, like, random girl?
Development specialist. This is level 3, and we are back at my gym. But this time, we're joined by Chelsea, who's a child development specialist. Most importantly, she's going to help you over...
I guess he gets a little more chill. I think he realized... You can see how he realizes how loud he's talking.
Back at my gym. But this time, we're joined by Chelsea, who's a child development specialist.
Wait.
Longer than 3 seconds.
You still pop!
He gets so embarrassed mid-sentence.
Get over it. This is level 3, and we are back at my gym. But this time, we're joined by Chelsea, who's a child development specialist. Most importantly, she's going to help you overcome your fear of Zadie going down the stairs.
We got our special toys.
Like
to
whispering
Zadie
by the end.
Encourage her.
Okay.
She jump scared. Wait, did she really?
Get over it.
Did she jump?
This is level 3, and we are back at my gym. But this time, we're joined by Chelsea, who's a child development.
Okay.
Toys to help Zadie, to encourage her.
Okay.
Yo, where are the shot glasses?
We're gonna start her over here. Zadie has not actually crawled yet, which is what we're learning.
Oh, she likes this one. You like this one, Zadie.
You got your legs moving. She wants it, Mom. Look
at
that.
Oh, wow.
Can we move it a little further?
Oh.
How about that?
Should we just maybe give it to her so she doesn't have to reach?
Very challenging.
Rebecca, think about what happened earlier.
Look. There we go.
She's only whining because she wants the toy?
She plays me so hard. Maybe we could just go on the floor because we haven't done stairs and she can't crawl, so maybe it's like floor might be better. Look, she's pushing up. But she almost fell.
I know, Mom.
What if I just kind of...
Is crawling a thing that babies need to, like, be really taught? Let alone, like, why are they speed running it? Like, all in one day? You know what I'm saying?
Stop
like
Zadie from crawling. Like, I just make sure she's always sitting so she can't practice.
Well, I understand that fear. As a mom myself, I never wanted my baby to fall, ever. I always wanted to protect her. It kind of leads to a type of laziness. Mom's biggest fear.
Yeah, I don't want Zadie to be lazy!
So you're saying if I stop my daughter effects, from crawling, dude, I'm basically stopping her from growing? Yes, there will be a delay in growth. I don't want that to happen to her. That's why we're here to help out, Mama.
So do you think Zadie is gonna crawl by the end of today?
Well, Mom, I don't think that she's quite ready just yet, and you might not be ready yourself. And that's okay.
Well, then what did I watch the video for? And what am I going to do for the rest of the 8 minutes? I have to go. Good night, peace. So this was a fun stream. Thanks for being here, Magda. Bye. Bye, bye, bye.
Hey, Zade. You did those stairs. I think it's time we...
He's going to crawl by the end of the day, but Matt thinks... Did you hear what she said? She doesn't think Zadie's gonna crawl by the end of the day, but Matt thinks she will. Right now, I just need to focus on the fact that she's about to go down the big stairs for the first time.
We are gonna do this safely, and we're gonna put Zadie right up here.
Okay, I can't watch this anymore. I mean, she goes down a slide into manure.
With my first child.
And then they invite over more children that are in these YouTube videos without wanting to be, and everyone claps. Okay, so why does that BTTV work? Okay, claps work. Awesome. Now what? I showed you guys Rebecca. I love that, like, the way that I went from... I had, like, a deep talk with you guys about, like, the future of Piso 4. And then, like, immediately went to Rebecca Zamolo. Like, it's actually funny. Did anyone respond to Roblox? No. If they do late tonight, I'll probably go live again. Because I went live, what, 3 hours ago? If they went, I definitely, like, could do Roblox. But I did give you guys, like, a longer stream, so hopefully that was good. Darman, I can't do it, dude. I can only do so much children's YouTube content in my brain. Alt stream or main? It'd probably be main. But, yeah, I think I just stream on my main again, but I want to go eat. I need more water too. Darman stream. I think Darman is also really overdone in the like commentary space. Please don't make us watch another Rebecca video. Guys, you know, you loved it. You should watch Collins Key. Hasn't Danny Gonzalez done a video on Collins Key? I think so. I used to watch Collins Key when I was younger. But that was, like, before Collins Key was, like, a brand. Collins Key is, like, not... Yeah. I would love to keep doing, like, commentary and all that kind of stuff. I'm glad you guys like it. Do you guys like the, like, commentary, chill little streams I do? I don't think it's as mainstream as the other stuff I do, but, good to know that you guys like it. Also, notifications on Twitch can get sent out every 4 hours. I've been streaming for 3. I'm gonna end. So if you see me back, just know that it won't be within the next hour. And it also might not literally might not be at all. So I'll let you guys know. Okay, wait, would you put YouTube video bloopers on your Patreon? Yes. Wait, do you guys want to see what my Patreon? Hold on. Okay, wait, Patreon membership things? Let's take a little look at this, because I do have all of them, I have that all planned out. You guys want to see? Okay, here's the plan. Thank you for the sub, BMX Zozo, thank you. Loki might get tier 3, that'd be awesome. Okay, so guys, I want to explain this before we raid out. I don't know if I'll raid out. Maybe I won't. But if you're interested in this, here it is. Is this the button? Yo, thanks for the raid. Okay. This page, I think, is up right now, but you can't join. So, like, don't go try to join, because I don't think that your payment will go through, and there's also no content there. So, I'm still working on names for these, but let's take a little look. Let me just do a little split-screen moment. Yeah? Do you like these little cats, guys? Okay. Here is the Patreon plan. Okay, and let me know what you think. I'd love feedback. So this one, this tier, hold on, let me move this over. Okay, this tier, extra content, video, pictures, text posts, more. Then also podcasts. I'm gonna start a podcast, but it's going to be exclusive. It's gonna be exclusively Impossible Choice verified on Twitter or Piso Patreon. So true. This podcast is gonna be exclusively on Patreon, and it's also gonna have some guests on it as well. So, like, some other creators that you guys might like. But mainly just me, but I think I might have guests on it as well. Also, shopping hauls, and I'll say where I got everything from instead of gatekeeping where I got my clothes from. Sharing my favorite movies, songs, TikToks, recipes, YouTubers, other media, so we can enjoy it together. Q&A submissions, you can ask me anything, I'll do some answering. Also, sneak peeks and behind the scenes of upcoming content, and then anything else that I can think of. Okay, that's tier one. Sound okay? Sound cool? Sound awesome? That's $5 a month, which is the same as the sub that you might be paying for right now, which all Twitch sub does is make sure that you don't have ads and you get emotes. This is, like, so much more bang for your buck. So, I don't know. I want to give you guys a place where you can still support me, but you can actually get something out of it, you know? I don't want it to seem like a cash grab or anything like that. I just feel like subs feel cash grabby to me, because that's genuinely, like, you barely get anything from a sub, you know what I'm saying? Okay, exclusive voting power, vote on polls and help me make decisions about content. Also, ad-free videos, so any YouTube videos that I post will also be posted on my Patreon, so you can watch them as many times as you want and download them without ads. Also, unreleased content, so any content that I have, a ton of content that I'll film, or just like intros to videos or middle parts to videos or little things that I'll film and edit, or like just discarded footage that never made the final cut, it'll go there. Those are little three extra things. And then the only other thing that's difference between the tier two and the tier three is that I'll put the music that I make, so like any improvised songs or songs that I make on stream, or maybe songs that I just like am messing around with, like little joke songs, I'll put them there so you can download them, stream them, etc. And then the last thing is general support, which is like, sorry, I feel like I'm giving like a presentation right now. General support, which is just like monetary support to help me continue to make content and pay bills. Yay! There's all the Patreon stuff. And if that doesn't interest you, that's totally fine. You just being here supports me just enough. Do you guys like this song? I don't want to get copyrighted, but... I can't play anymore. I'll get copyrighted, but that song is so good. Thanks for being here. I'm gonna end. Maybe I'll be back in an hour. Maybe I'll be back in 2 hours. Maybe I won't be back at all. But if you're still up, I might be still kicking, maybe playing some Roblox with friends. I appreciate you being here, sticking around for a while. Thanks for letting me vent like a little Among Us guy. I actually feel so much better after the stream, like genuinely so much better. I think it was good to just have like I think it was good to like tell you guys all the things in my brain. What song was that? It was When Can I See You Again, from Wreck-It Ralph by Owl City. Hope you enjoyed it. Follow my Twitter, subscribe to my YouTube. Thanks for being here. Say derp when you see this. When you hear this. See you all later. Bye 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 bye
Maybe. Okay, I'm leaving. Keep on derping. Also, VOD Watchers. Everyone say hi to the VOD Watchers because I'm not rating out. So, VOD Watchers, you're so cool. What? You're so awesome. Thanks for watching the VOD. Bye, guys. Bye, 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 bye